into the day with the dawn ringing in my ears. Oh, well, I tune into my TV show. No better way, I gotta get myself into gear. Let's go. Very good morning to you and welcome. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Espresso on S3. I'm Zoe Brown and I'm not alone. Good morning, Grant Hines.
Yes, I'm Grant Hines.
Yes.
Thank you, Zoe Brown.
Lots of exciting things coming up on the show. You know, exams are starting on Monday until the 5th of December. Ooh. So I think for the matriculants, you need to probably be as prepared as possible, not only for before and after the exams, but for a little break. Is there something you would suggest for a break?
Yes, there's something that you can look forward to. I'm going to be playing Spider-Man 2 on the show. Like, I'm so excited. This is like 10 out of 10. This is my childhood. It's going to be my child's childhood because they're going to be playing Spider-Man.
She's growing up in that space.
Yes, she can enjoy Spider-Man. And I'm telling you, I'm not just being biased. It is an incredible game.
Oh, okay. We'll have to wait and see. Are you going to unpack it a little bit more? Give us a bit of a demo.
I will do, but Cole's hugging the TV.
Oh, so already? I don't know. Is it one of those games?
If he's going to let me get onto the TV and play some.
Oh, he's nice. He'll be fine. He's nice. But you know what? Also coming up on the show, we're going to be celebrating Pride Month, and we've got so much to unpack. And then Shudufatsu is in Johannesburg. Kuhle will be connecting with her live. And this is all about her brand new children's book and swimsuit line that she has launched with Woolworths. So that is a lot of excitement. And that's just a snippet of what's to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. But you said Wastey's hogging the TV.
He is. Carl, can I have the control back, please?
Spider-Man 2, it's been the most amazing game. I've seen it all over the place, and I really want to play it today. So, Grant, I need you to come through and just show me a bit more about Spider-Man 2, in fact, throughout the show. That's what's going to happen. It actually makes me think about animations. And the thing is, everybody's got an animation you can go to over and over again, and it makes you feel good. Personally, Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs has my humor. That's a show that I watch over and over again when it comes to animation. Other than that, I'd say Lion King, but that's a bit of a hartzia stick, but it's fine because I feel like it's beautiful that you can have an animation you can go back to. It's comforting, it's nostalgic, but of course, even if it's one of the Spider-Man comics, whatever that may be, an animation like that, well, like the game, of course, you can just drop that in there on 063-408-8863. We would love to check it out, and of course, make sure we get the animation that you require and share a bit more about why it is the one that you go to as we get into news from around the world, and Zoe is standing by.
Oh, thank you, Wastey. Well, let's start off with your national headlines. All the miners from the Gold One mine in Springs on the East Rand have been brought to surface. The miners have been underground since Sunday. The Deputy Secretary General of the National Union of Mine Workers, Paul Paketi, says a total of 563 miners, including senior management members, had been held hostage by other miners who had demanded that trade union AMCU be recognized by the Gold One mine. No details of the negotiations which took place are available as yet. And staying with our local news, Rand Water CEO Sipho Mosai says the water problems in Gauteng can be largely attributed to a lack of maintenance. The province have been struggling for months with water shortages due to infrastructure that isn't maintained and load shedding that causes problems with water pumps. Mosai says this has led to the implementation of water interruptions to ensure sustainable water supply. He was addressing members of the media at Rand Water's head office in Glen Vista, Johannesburg. Moving to news beyond our own borders, Nigeria has begun a mass vaccination campaign against human papillomavirus, known as HPV, in a bid to drastically reduce the rate of cervical cancer. HPV, a common virus usually spread through intimate sexual contact, can, in a minority of cases, lead to cervical cancer. In 2021, a major study found that the HPV vaccine was reducing cases of cervical cancer by nearly 90%. The nationwide campaign began yesterday, and the Health Ministry aims to vaccinate some 16.6 million girls aged between 9 and 14 by the end of 2025. Staying with news abroad, Mexicans are bracing themselves for Hurricane Otis, which is set to hit the country later today. The National Hurricane Center warns that giant waves and flooding could occur along the coastal areas, which include the popular resort of Acapulco. Otis has strengthened to the Category 5 storm within a matter of hours. Storm warnings are in effect in the state of Guerrero, where soldiers have been deployed along the beaches. A wind speed of more than 250 kilometers per hour and heavy rain is expected. And bringing it back home, Cape Town's V&A Waterfront Marina has, for the fifth year running, been awarded Blue Flag status for excellence in safety, amenities, cleanliness, and meeting environmental standards. Eight city beaches have also been awarded Blue Flag status by the Wildlife Environmental Society of South Africa. V&A Waterfront Head of Communications, Donald Kao, said this recognition talks to their commitment to tourism, but also to the preservation of the marine ecosystem at the V&A Waterfront environment, as it also very much is a working harbour. The iconic blue flag is one of the world's most recognised voluntary eco-labels, awarded to beaches, marinas and sustainable boating tourism operators. Well, that is certainly amazing. That's where I leave your headlines. Let's take a first look at your sport.
Thanks a lot, Zoe. Let's take a look at your sporting action. And in a statement from World Rugby, it's confirmed that in the Rugby World Cup final at Stade de France, the Springboks and All Blacks will sport their iconic uniforms. The Springboks will be in their traditional green and gold jerseys with white shorts and green socks, while New Zealand will be dressed in black. With six of the nine World Cup titles shared between them, these teams post remarkable success. It's noteworthy that the Springboks and the All Blacks met in a final just once back in 1995 when the Springboks clinched their first Webb Ellis Cup in Johannesburg's Ellis Park. Now, staying with rugby, Argentina has made adjustments to their lineup for the Rugby World Cup's bronze medal clash against England in Paris tomorrow. And of course, coach Michael Checa has introduced Pedro Rubiolo, as well as Thomas Cobelli and Geronimo de la Fuente in the starting 15, emphasizing their commitment to concluding the tournament positively. England's experienced duo of Amano Tuolagi as well as Ben Youngs will also feature in what might be their final England appearances, while Tom Curry is set to make his 50th England appearance. The bronze medal match between Argentina and England is scheduled for Friday at 9 p.m. On to cricket action. Glenn Maxwell's blazing century in just 40 balls, along with David Warner's impressive 104, propelled Australia to a record-breaking 309-run win against the Netherlands yesterday. Australia posted an imposing total of 399 for the loss of 8, and their bowlers made quick work of the Dutch, dismissing them for a mere 90 in 21 overs in New Delhi. This win surpassed Australia's previous record victory margin in the World Cup, set against Afghanistan in 2015 with a 275-run margin. After a shaky start with two losses, Australia has now secured three consecutive wins, solidifying their fourth place in the 10-team table as they aim for the semi-finals. Now onto football. Banyana played to a 1-1 draw against the Democratic Republic of Congo in their first leg of the 2024 CAF Women's Olympic qualifier at Stade des Martyrs. Of course, that was on Wednesday, just last night. DR Congo dominated early, but Kaelin Swart's goalkeeping kept them at bay. Grace Mfuamba scored for the hosts in the 40th minute, and Banyana struggled, but Temi Khatlana's brilliant strike, assisted by Nicole Michael, brought them level in the 48th minute. Banyana has an edge with the away goal, but DR Congo remains a formidable opponent for the second leg at Orlando Stadium in Soweto on Monday, the 30th of October 2023. That's it for your sporting action. Let's take a first look at your weather.
Thank you, Wasey. Well, the SA Weather Services have warned that heat wave conditions resulting in persistently high temperatures are expected in places over Gauteng and the eastern parts of Northwest until tomorrow. Johannesburg Emergency Services has urged residents to take precautions against the heat. Residents are urged to stay hydrated, drink large quantities of water, and stay out of direct sunlight between 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. in the afternoon. Meanwhile, extremely high fire danger conditions are once again expected over the western and central interior of the Northern Cape, the western parts, both the Free State and the Northwest provinces, as well as over the Beaufort West and Laingsburg municipalities in the Western Cape. So please look after yourself. Let's take a look at your temperatures for today. you're in Upington, brace yourself for a hot day, 42 degrees Celsius. Please stay hydrated and wear some sunblock. Now, we love sunrise views, and Ken from Keymouth shared his view, and this is what he had to say. Windy weather, but beautiful colors showcased in the cloudy skies. Thank you for this photo, Ken. We absolutely appreciate it. And if you would love to share your good morning view, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number's on your screen right now at 063-408-8863.
Well, I'm excited because after the break, we're going to be playing some Spider-Man 2, a game that I've been incredibly excited to get my hands on. And of course, we've got awareness for World Stroke Day, which is really, really important. So, yeah, we'll see you guys after the break.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show, and we bring you awareness about all kinds of things on the show. And today we're putting the spotlight on heart and vascular health ahead of World Stroke Day that is this coming Sunday. The biggest risk factor of having a stroke is having high and uncontrolled blood pressure. And here to unpack this topic for us and to just raise more awareness is CEO of the Heart and Stroke Foundation South Africa, Professor Pamela Naidu, who is back. And then joining us via video call in Johannesburg is stroke survivor Tennille Flint. We will be chatting to her as well. Prof, it's so great to have you here again. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for such an important topic. Very happy to be back.
Lovely. Even this early in the morning, which is always
even this
always
early
well,
in
right?
the morning, yeah.
So this is, I mean, you know, I think one thing that stands out to me is the fact that Tennille is so young as well, right? So I think there's a lot of stigmas attached to strokes and a lot of people who are wondering, you know, what is actually a stroke? And because, mm-hmm. you know, you get people having heart attacks and then people having strokes and you feel like it's the same thing. But unpack it for us in layman's terms. What is a stroke, actually?
Yeah, no, great question. So literally a stroke is a brain attack. And so it can happen at any age, excuse me, but as you get older, obviously you're more vulnerable, and okay. there's certain reasons why younger people would get that, but we'll get to that
yes,
later.
Yes, we will.
And essentially, I think for the public to be aware, there's a couple of types of strokes.
Okay.
But the common ones are basically around 3 to 4 of them.
Yeah.
The two most common ones are what we call the ischemic stroke, and there you have basically a blood clot that blocks the flow of blood literally through your circulatory system. And then if it gets lodged in the brain, what happens is obviously then you lose oxygen distribution throughout the body, but okay. particularly in the brain. And then your cells start to die off because of it.
Sure.
So that's the one type. The second type is what we call a hemorrhagic stroke. And that's literally bleeding into the brain. And the effect is similar. you know, you'll have lack of oxygen flow and your cells will start to die off. And obviously this, you know, your central nervous system is dependent on your ability to talk,
yes,
and walk and think and so on. And then you get what we call a TIA, which is a transient ischemic stroke. And that is, it happens so quickly, you kind of feel that you're having a stroke, and you probably do, but it's what they call a mini stroke.
Yeah.
And the symptoms can reverse. And then there's the fourth type, which is of unknown cause.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, so that's basically how you can classify the various types of strokes.
Now, Professor, you just mentioned you feel like you're having a stroke. What are those symptoms someone that potentially is going through a stroke, yeah, should be looking out for?
Yeah, that's a great question. The problem is that the person who's having a very serious stroke is not aware oftentimes.
Yeah.
You know, maybe a bit of uneasiness, but you actually don't know, because in that split second, you can start to lose function on one side of your body. So the awareness that we want to create is that those around you have to know what the symptoms of a stroke are.
Okay.
Yeah, even the little ones, you know, where the go-go's are looking after them and so on, and grandma and, you know, and the grandparents, basically. And essentially, the acronym FAST is very easy to remember. The T is not the symptom, but I'll get there. So,
yeah.
So if it's on, you know, either the left side or the right side,
okay,
and so it's what happens is that half of your body becomes disproportionate to the other half.
Okay.
So starting with the face, you'll find there's drooping on the one side. If you ask the person to lift up their arm, they can't hold it up voluntarily.
Oh.
It will just, like, basically,
okay,
then you, yeah, absolutely. So that's A for arm, you know, in the FAST. And speech. It,
yes,
may not always happen. But you're trying to call, you're trying to tell me, I feel something's happening, but I can't, it's unintelligible. I can't understand,
okay,
a single thing you say. So that's the speech gets very affected. And T is basically to get the person to an emergency care on time,
okay,
timelessly. Because the quicker you get to emergency services, the better the outcome. So, you know, stroke can be reversed to a large degree if you're in a specialist unit.
Okay.
And then rehabilitation will help you even further. So it's pretty serious, you know?
Yes.
The disability from stroke is one of the most costly things, I should say.
Yeah.
Because it costs the family, the individual, and the country at large. Because if you're having younger people with stroke, they're in a productive age, and so you lose people in the workforce.
Well, let's get a first-hand experience from a stroke survivor. In
exactly.
fact, Tanil, I'd love to bring you in here. So, Tanil, first and foremost, welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Thank you so much for sharing your story with us. But as you can hear from Professor, you know, we're getting some insights, but you have first-hand experience. So, you know, as a stroke survivor, you know, kind of take us through your particular situation. And, of course, please tell us a bit more about what type of treatments have helped you regain your health.
Thank you very much. I'm honored to be here today. So I suffered a stroke at birth at 1 day old.
Oh my word.
The doctors don't know what happened and why or why I had the stroke, but I did. And then I was discharged after a month, and my mom and my dad started therapy with me. We went to physios and OTs and all of that. And they did various therapy things with me. And I regained the mobility on my left side because I was a left hemiplegic. And I developed normally after that. And then unfortunately, when I turned 12, I developed epilepsy due to the lesion on my brain from my first stroke at birth. And the epilepsy became so bad that I was having up to 25 petit-mal seizures a day. And we went to different neurologists and they put me on different medication, and some of it worked, some of it didn't. So I eventually went down to Cape Town and they placed electrodes on my head to see exactly where the epilepsy was coming from. And after that week, the doctor said they had insufficient information, so they had to operate, and they actually stitched the electrodes onto my brain.
Oh, my word.
And this was a 5.5-hour operation. After that, I stayed like that for a week, and then they found exactly where the epilepsy was coming from, and this, and they were ready to operate. This was a 9.5 hour operation.
Sure.
And either during the operation or after the operation, I suffered a blood clot, and this caused 2 strokes. So I was a left hemiplegic at 16 years old.
Sure.
And what happened, what happened afterwards was that I was still in hospital and they monitored me and everything. And once I was ready, I flew back to Joburg and I went, I started rehab. I had to learn how to walk, how to get dressed, how to brush my teeth. Things that we all take for granted, such as tying your hair or putting your earrings in, I had to relearn. And it was really difficult because, especially since I was so young, normally you would think that strokes happen to much older people. And I felt alone and I felt very, very depressed in a way because I didn't know what was going to happen and how I was going to recover. But what helped me the most was the support of my family who kept me going. And I started exercising right away. I went to gym. I started the horse riding for the disabled. I've done everything. I've done hydrotherapy for in the water. I've gone to many physios and many OTs. And the trick is that you have to find the OT and the physio that suits you. And you will have physios and OTs that you don't click with. And then I just knew that I had to move on and go to the next one. So it's a journey. It really is. And throughout this whole journey, I've learned so many things. That's where I learned about Botox. And I didn't know that Botox could be used for stroke patients, and the Botox has actually helped me a lot in regards to reducing the tone on my left side.
Oh.
And the different types of exercises I had to do. The most influential person who really helped me was my personal trainer, Grant, who I met at the gym, actually, and he pushed me, he got me going. And when I first started with him, my arm was up to my side and I couldn't put it down. My foot was going inwards and I couldn't get it out. And I struggled to, for example, walk upstairs. And after a few months working with him, I was able to walk up and down stairs and he eventually got me running.
Yeah. Tanil, that
so
is unbelievable.
It takes a lot of hard work.
Yeah. And we are so grateful that you got to share your journey with us. And I know, like you said, it is a long one. And we are, you know, so grateful that you were able to share that. Prof, I just wanted to ask you, she was young. It happened at birth for her. You said there's that one category where it can happen at any age. Who is more prevalent to receiving a stroke?
It's true. At a younger age, yeah.
Just in general, just as in well, general. Who should be careful?
Yeah, what a story. So that's amazing. But I think it's a classic case of, there's two sort of classes of reasons, if you like, of what would drive someone having, you know, to suffer a stroke. One is it's what we call unmodifiable factors. So it's, you know, it's your genetic inherited traits, you know, you can't change your gene code. It's, again, family history, but it's also structural to some degree. You know, you don't know what happened in utero, the baby's development. So that's kind of the one class of reasons. The other is actually what we call modifiable, which means that there's certain behaviors you can change to improve your chances of not getting a stroke. Yeah. And that class is, you know, the usual risk factors. Tobacco smoking is an absolute no-no. And it's one of the reasons I believe younger people are becoming, not at the age of you know, one day, but certainly teenagers and young adults, or they're probably taking illicit drugs. So there's a lot of those combination of factors, excessive alcohol consumption, obesity, lack of exercise, poor diet, and hypertension.
Yeah.
Well, you mentioned hypertension at the beginning of the program or the session.
Yeah.
It's really one of the key drivers. And younger people are, you know, becoming more prone to being hypertensive, particularly young children, because they are more obese than they were 20 years ago. Because parents are not cooking those healthy meals our moms and grandmoms made at the time, you know.
This has been an amazing info session. Thank you so much for sharing, Professor.
Absolutely.
It's been incredible. To Neil, to you, for your story as well. It's been wonderful to raise awareness for what is us, you know, being critically mindful around heart disease as well as stroke risk factors. And just remember, you are not alone in this. There are resources available to you. You can indeed be greater than stroke.
Join us as we inspire hope across South Africa on Friday, the 27th of October. It's the Hopetober Takeover right here on Expresso. Brought to you by Adcock Ingram OTC, sponsors of Brave. We bring you inspiring guests, messages of hope, and live performances for Mzansi. Plus, you stand a chance of winning 1,500 Rand cash every hour on the show. So mark your calendars and get ready for a morning of hope. Friday, the 27th of October, only on S3.
It's your feel-good breakfast show, Expresso here at S3, and one of the most anticipated games of the year, it's finally here. Spider-Man 2, the long-awaited sequel to Marvel's Spider-Man on PlayStation, is here. It's got massive shoes to fill, but how is it fair? And that's why we got Grant Hines to give us the rundown of Spider-Man 2, the experience of this. I've seen a lot of content on this all over social. And this game seems to be one of the best.
I want to show you how impressive
please
this game is.
Do it.
Look, it's remarkable. You've got this open world of New York City that you get to like swing around and live our dreams. You know, when you were a kid, you wanted to be Spider-Man. Well, check this out. There's New York City. There's the Empire State Building. We're in the Financial District. Let's dive down into the city and then just swing through it. So if you've ever played, look right past the helicopter, because we can, you know what I mean? And then it's such a great feeling. You get to play as Miles Morales and Peter Parker the city, which is really cool. And then also, you've got this new ability called a wingsuit. So the traversal is what they call it, is so much better. It's just so cool. The city's been a little bit demolished. We fought Sandman. You know Sandman?
Yes.
Yeah, so we've just fought him. One of the most incredible battles. Did you enjoy God of War, the old God of Wars?
Yes, I used to love those.
Do you know those big epic battle scenes?
Kratos.
You get them here.
But you play the same thing.
Same kind of thing. They're just super epic and they're really impressive. The graphics are like something else. We're playing this right now in a high fidelity mode, which is 60 frames a second, which gives you that feeling of speed. You can't see it at home, unfortunately. But it does. And look, you can see yourself in the mirror of a building. There's even a little bit of a room inside this of all the buildings in the city.
Yeah.
Like you can see yourself in it. And then obviously when we go down, let's hit the floor of the city. I really want to show you how impressive the actual like world is, because
Sandman.
You know, Sandman has destroyed everything here. But people walk around, you get that full feeling, and then obviously the combat is all there. And the story is something I don't want to spoil for anybody, but Kraven, you know Kraven the Hunter?
Yes.
Okay, so this is throwback. We're going to be doing a binge it or bash a little bit later with cartoons. So Kraven the Hunter is descending on New York City to find the best, the toughest people to hunt. And who's the toughest person in the universe?
To hunt, of course, it's Spider-Man. You know,
it's Venom.
What?
Venom.
Venom.
Venom. In the Spider-Man. Listen, your Spider-Man lore needs to crank up a bit. Actually, I would argue that it's Carnage, but Venom would be a really good one to hunt.
Oh, I see.
And that starts happening. So there's Venom in this game, which is incredible. Having this open world with Venom, I'm not going to give too much of that story away because it's absolutely remarkable. This game is getting full 10 out of 10s everywhere.
I can see that.
It's one of the most cinematic, immersive experiences that you're going to be getting in a video game. Just relive your dreams.
This is fantastic. So while you do gameplay, some of the bigger characters, you mentioned the likes of Kraven, Sandman, you mentioned Venom as well. Are there any other characters that have popped up in the content you've seen?
Well, Electro, you get the whole, like, there's just it's just surprising.
Yeah.
Let's just jump. Oh, man, the city is just so impressive.
This is fantastic. And you know what I love about the gameplay as well is that it just, as you said, that real-time feeling that you can go anywhere.
I want you to try it, actually. Do you want to give it a go? Are you scared? Why are you so scared?
I'm ready because I might not let it. I might not put it down. I'm such a big Spider-Man, fan. And I mean, with the last game I played was an old-school PlayStation Spider-Man game.
Oh no, we're on another level now, bro.
This is completely different. Also, I wanted to ask you about, the fact that games like the GTA and games that kind of that free-play game where you can kind of go anywhere and almost like make your own missions.
Yes.
Do you feel the same with Spider-Man 2? Is it that type of feeling?
There is the open world part of it is more about getting around, but you want to get through the story.
Yeah.
And the story is just totally worth it. There are a lot of side quests that you want to do and complete. Yes.
Yes.
But like, there's not a lot of like messing around like GTA. But that's fine. Spider-Man doesn't mess around. GTA, you might mess around.
Yeah. This is fantastic. Well, Spider-Man 2 out officially, of course. Peter Parker and Miles Morales is what you can play as, which is fantastic. So it's an exciting new adventure. Get your hands on it because it's going to be mind-blowing. We see what social media is like with regard to this game. It's guaranteed to be something that will live up to its name. So make sure you grab yours. Spider-Man 2 out on PlayStation now.
Oh, well, listen, we're about to have a little bit of fun with a game of Binge It or Bash It. Now, I'm going to invite Wasty and Grant to come and join me because hold tight to your remotes because it's time for our game. So today's theme is popular animated movies, but we have a panel and we need to find out, is it popular with them? So let's find out as we play a game of Binge It or Bash It, and hopefully you can play at home as well. So gents, how it's going to work is I'm going to give you some popular animated movies. You need to let me know whether you would binge it or bash it. Bash it means it's not your vibe. Binge it, yes, all the way. Are you ready?
Ready.
Let's do this.
Okay, our first one, Shrek.
Bash it.
Really?
Yeah, not my vibe.
Oh, you'll binge.
I'll binge, yeah, a donkey.
Donkey.
Purely for donkey.
Hey, Puss in Boots is great.
Yes.
Yo, that was good, but the...
Oh. So you'll bash it. Okay.
Bash everything else.
Frozen.
Binge, actually.
Binge.
It's a very good movie.
I feel like you'll binge it because of your little girl.
Yeah, and I'm going to run around.
Yeah.
How does it go?
Let it go.
Let it go. Don't worry, I'll have that memorized soon. Yeah.
Moana.
Binge.
Actually, yeah. Watched it the other day for the first time.
You're welcome.
How nice.
Yeah.
Toy Story.
Binge. That movie is really good.
Great.
And there's multiple ones. We're focusing on the originals here.
Yeah.
Finding Nemo.
Binge.
Bash. I know. You're shocked. I watched it again the other day. Yeah. It's not the animation doesn't actually stand up, and like the soundtrack.
It's the humor for me. Okay, Escape.
Yes.
Encanto.
Yes. Binge. Amazing.
I love how Wastey's binging everything. I'm with you on this.
I love animation. I think that's the movies that calm me down the most. The animations.
I love them.
It's like Wall-E. Take back to your childhood.
Yeah.
Wall-E.
Yes, please. Binge.
Yeah, binge. Yeah, I like binge.
Also, Wall-E had a bit of forecasting to what the world is like at the moment, you know, with everything automated. You just have to sit in your chair. And there's this great scene in there where everybody is overweight.
Yes.
And just in their little devices there, and everything's done for them. And I think Wall-E had a bit of that sort of a future prediction over there to go to that movie.
Definitely. We have got Despicable Me.
Oh, yes. That, for me, it's a bit.
Bash it, man. Oh,
but it's the Minions. We have a Minion voice right here.
You know what? The Minions were terrible, but the latest ones are actually not bad. I started watching them, and it's a little bit like Charlie Chaplin, right? It's a little bit of its own personality.
I'm on the binge train.
No, man,
I'm on the binge train. Okay, last two.
Yes.
The Lion King, the original version.
Oh, binge it.
Yeah, over and over again.
I was just going to say bash it.
No,
you paused.
No.
Why did you pause?
Because I was thinking about all the lines in the movie that I can think of as well. You know, I can see what's happening, and they don't have a clue. They'll fall in love, and here's the bottom line. Our trio's down to two. Oh, sorry. Came out of me.
I love that. Help me. And would you binge or bash the Lion King, the... live remake animation, whatever you call it, the live action version.
Bash it. Those, I don't know what it is. Those live remakes don't really capture the magic of those old movies.
Yeah. I would actually bash as well. Because
I
like the original, gave me the original. I mean, I think that's the thing. It's just like my first time I proper had a cry. You know,
I think every child has that moment when they realize Simba's dad is no longer.
What was your favorite animation of all time?
My favorite? Oh my gosh, I don't have one. I think I'll have to go with Finding Nemo only because I found it hilarious to this day.
Yeah.
Okay,
I can watch Nemo over.
I thought it would be
over.
A cat-related movie, but it's fine.
No.
Swimming.
And yours?
Swimming and that sort of thing. I love Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs, just purely for the humor is wonderful in that. I mean, they've done that so well. So I love that. I watch it quite often when I get a chance to.
So The Land Before Time.
Oh, man.
I cried. I watched it again the other day. I cried That's again. Beautiful. I'm a grown man. And also Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, probably the greatest film ever made. Not only the greatest animated film, but the greatest film ever made. It is really, really good. That movie did not deserve to be as good as it was.
Oh, well, listen, we can talk movies all day, every day. But why don't you get your binge on? Because you need two things, fast internet and access to the best streaming platforms. And thankfully, with Vodacom Enhance, you get to have both. Now, you can enhance your plan to access 10 mega MPs home internet from 299 Rand per month over 36 months. And you can sign up for Prime Video for 79 Rand per month and get the first 3 months for free. But there are more internet deals to choose from and more streaming platforms available. So check it out. You can visit it at Yoda. In fact, it's voda.com/enhance.
Mzansi, enhance what you love. Add more of what you need to your contract. Choose from a range of enhanced options in-store or online. Further together. Vodacom.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Espresso and you're live at S3 and we are responsible for owning our own future, of course. But when it comes to the tips and tools we need for that ultimate success, the professionals are there to lend a helping hand as they always are. Now here to delve more into the topic is our panel of experts. We've got Kristen Wolfenden, of course, from the founder of Tutorific Academic Tutoring Center, Tulani Maposa, tutor at Teach Me Too, and Megan O'Dea, an educational psychologist. I mean, could you find a better panel? Of course not. We found them for you, which is so important. But welcome, everybody. How are you guys ready for your exam with me?
Mm-hmm.
You see, that tension. That's what a lot of people are feeling at the moment. But of course, this is about success. And I mean, this time of the year, we've got a lot of those end of year exams and that's something happening. But when it comes to being prepared, I think this is the most important thing. This is why we have a panel. So let's go to Tutorific first and foremost, Chris. When it comes to being prepared, right? The preparedness, I think they always look at book prepared. Good stuff. But no one ever really speaks about the other parts of preparation. You know, there's setting up, creating a good context to make sure that the information can be absorbed appropriately, etc. So let's look at the word preparation and being prepared. What does that mean to somebody of your particular context being a part of Tutorific?
Well, I think being prepared means having all the information, the confidence that you need to go into the exam. If you don't have if you don't have the sufficient knowledge behind, you know, your work, then you don't have the same confidence, and then it can cause students to go into the exam and feel anxious and then blank during the exams, and it just really can make the exam process very difficult.
And let's talk about, you know, note-taking and having good summaries and good revision opportunities as well. I think people want to take everything in a big chunk. Would you recommend that, or do you need to break it down?
Yeah, definitely. I think so the note-taking technique I always teach is to rephrase your notes as questions.
Okay.
And so that way when you're studying, you're not just rereading over the work, you're just where it's very easy to, you know, just blur out and kind of reread the words, but not actually process the information. So if you rephrase the work as questions and then quiz yourself on those questions, then it helps you to actively learn the work and therefore also be able to put it out on an exam.
And I think it's great to teach yourself the work because you tend to remember that better. Talking about teaching, Teach Me Too, Tulani. Do you have the same type of angle on revision and also preparedness with regard to exam time? I mean, for you, what do you think is key at this particular moment in terms of summarizing the work and getting all the material in?
So for me, I believe that preparedness has to be also psychological and mental.
Yes.
So you need to be calm. You need to, I believe, in meditating.
Yes.
So meditate. Oh, lovely. Yes, meditate. Be comfortable with yourself, be confident with yourself. Because what usually happens is that you're not necessarily not knowing the information. You know the information you've studied.
Yes.
But what you just need to have is confidence in yourself that you can actually do what you need to do. So on the day of the examination or the test, you know, I've studied very well. I know everything that I've done. I just need to believe in myself that I can deliver.
Uh-huh.
I can sit in there, I can just let information flow. So that preparedness from the mental point of view, as well as physical, I believe that jogging, just like walking or exercising, just helps you before you study. Just be active, just open up your mind to just accept information, be focused. Because when you move your body, when you exercise, you find that when you sit down to study, you actually, information flows a little bit better when you study it, as opposed to I just like wake up and I just like study, you fall asleep. So physical preparedness, exercise, walk around, jog if you can, and also mental, believe in yourself, have confidence that you
Affirmation. That's the question, right? But naturally, we have an educational psychologist, Megan, and I think that there's been a lot of studies on the fact that, you know, increased cortisol is not going to do much for anybody who actually needs to not only fight or flight, but also to focus. That increased, you know, blood pressure, etc., it happens. So when you do feel stress coming along, from an educational psychologist perspective, are there any things that, number one, what do you note in yourself, you know, when you are knowing that the stress is getting a bit too much? And then when do you plug in an intervention, and what would that intervention be for you? What would you recommend to any student now?
So I would say that, you know, when our body is in a state of stress, and it's really difficult for our minds to access and recall information. So some of the things that we would do, for example, is breathing exercises. It's really about regulating your body so that you are able to access that part of your brain that can recall and remember information.
Yes.
And our bodies and our minds are quite amazing, but naturally, if you're in a state of fight or flight or your nervous system is extremely activated, it's very difficult for you to recall and access information. So I would say number one is actually to get your body to a point where it's feeling calm and regulated, and we do that through breathing, for example. Like Thulani's mentioned, exercise, things like that. If you can feel your anxiety levels are going up, even during an exam, things like breathing can just help you to regulate your system so that you are able to then access that part of your brain that is able to recall information.
So in light of all of this, I feel like sometimes prevention is better than cure. So just to get back to you, Kristen, in terms of time management, what would you recommend, obviously pre-exam, in terms of managing your day and your time? Because it's always good to have some sort of a schedule. In fact, that actually calms you down, knowing that you have a to-do list. So any recommendation for students in terms of time management at this particular stage?
Yeah, I find with time management, it's really hard to just say, I'm going to study for 3 hours and not have any concrete goals. It makes it feel really overwhelming.
Yeah.
And it can make, when students feel overwhelmed, then they can just kind of give up.
Yeah.
So I like students to break it down into specific things that they want to cover, so specific goals that they have, like, you know, I'm going to go over these specific notes, I'm going to try this past paper, I'm going to do these, you know, exact things. And that makes it something that you can check off a to-do list, and therefore you need to get that sense of satisfaction when you're checking it off, and it also can help keep you motivated and keep you studying.
Time management is very, very important. It also drops the cortisol levels quite a bit if you know that you have a to-do list to tick off, including meditation, including identifying, checking in with yourself as well, I would believe, is also very, very critical to kind of know where you stand. I'm going to exercise my time management now and say that thank you so much for joining us. It's been amazing, all three of you. And to every single grade 12 who is writing, we just want to say that we have your back. We are looking after you in the best way we can. And on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we'll bring in experts like this for any tips and tricks that you require. We have got your back. All the best. Good luck. And remember, meditation, affirmation, time management, take it into small bites. You will be fine. We are going to create that safe space for you right here on Expresso.
Oh, just brings me back to my studying days. Any snacks you snacked on during your studies?
Yes, I used to drink instant coffee and rusks.
Oh,
boys, that was the best late night, like, ooh, it'll keep me going.
It kept you going. Listen, we are here for all the exam prep and snacks throughout that journey. And get ready for a taste sensation, because we're about to embark on a chocolate adventure you won't want to miss.
We have got some exciting news to share. Oh yes, the biggest retailers, Upper M Zanzi, Game and Macro, are about to make history. They are set to be the first retailers in South Africa to stock and sell Mr. Beast Feastables chocolate bar, created by the successful YouTuber Mr. Beast himself. So I am here at Game to find out more. Follow me. Hi, ladies.
Hey, Kohle.
Hi, Kiste. How are you?
All good, thank you. Catherine, it's so good to see you. I see you guys are making sure that everything is set for all the excitement.
It's all happening. Customers are coming in and taking. We have to keep repacking already.
Talk to us about what inspired this decision.
Well, it's inspired by our brilliant merchants. The merchants in Macro actually brought this in for us, but we've used it across Macro and Games. We made sure that it is in all of our game stores today and online and in all of the Macro. So there's an abundance of stock. So yeah, please come and buy.
What are some of the unique flavors that sets Mr. Beast's Feastables apart from all other chocolate products?
I have tasted some of the milk chocolate flavor.
Oh, this one right here.
Yeah. This one right here, and it's really delicious. And then there's three others, the crunch, the Des Nuts, and then there's the vegan one.
The original chocolate.
Yeah. So we are on a mission, really, as Macro and Game, to bring it at really affordable prices. So these are only 50 Rand each, but we all want to win Mom and Dad of the Year.
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I cannot wait to try them out myself. Which one should I start with?
Maybe you should start with the peanut butter.
I'll start with these nuts. It's everything I thought it would be, and even more. I love it. We are about to ask a few customers about their thoughts on the arrival of festivals. Let's hear what they have to say. Sissy?
Hello.
Hi, good Jenny.
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm about to hijack you because I see you've got a few Feastables chocolate bars with you.
Yes.
Have you heard about Feastables before?
No, I didn't hear about Feastables before, mm-hmm. but my kids know about it. So I had to come here.
100% mommy of the year right here.
Yeah.
When you walked into game upon arrival and you saw Mr. Beast, Feastables chocolate bars, what was your first impression?
I was like, I better get some.
And which flavors did you get?
So I have crunch, I mm-hmm. have original chocolate, mm. and I have milk chocolate. I can't wait to taste.
Oh, it's gonna be a fun night at home.
It's
I'm
gonna
sad.
Be a feast.
Hi, beautiful lady.
Hello.
I had to interrupt because you came straight for Mr. Beast. Feastables mm-hmm. chocolate bars. I have to ask.
Yeah.
Have you heard about them before?
I had not until I saw the ads. Uh-huh. Then I asked because there was a big buzz about these chocolates. I asked my sons mm. if they knew Mr. Beast, and they definitely know him.
Oh.
So yeah, I'm getting them some Mr. Beast Feastables chocolates.
I'm pretty sure they are going to love you after
they
this.
Are. They...
Now I have to ask, upon arrival, when you saw these chocolates stacked up, yeah. what was your first impression?
I'm quite curious about the flavors.
Yeah.
I love dark chocolate, so mm. I'm going to try the original.
Going to be a feast.
Very excited.
Right?
Can't wait.
As of 20 October, all game and macro stores will stock four variants of the chocolate bars. Namely, original chocolate, the milk chocolate, crunch, and my favorite, these nuts. It's time for the Mr. Beast taste test. Let's dive into all of the flavors right here. I'm gonna start out with the milk chocolate right now. Oh, I feel like this is gonna be my favorite one. Let's see. Mmm, it's rich. It's milky, very, very flavorful. Now it's time for the original chocolate. Mm-hmm. So far, 10 out of 10 quality, rich and flavorful chocolate. Mr. Beast's Feastables are in town officially. Mm-hmm. How excited are you?
I'm very excited.
Mm-hmm. Have you heard about them before today?
Oh yes, I was actually one of the few people that have been waiting for this brand to come to South Africa.
And when it finally arrived, what were your first impressions and thoughts?
I love it because I'm a big fan. I'm one of the 200 million subscribers, so I'm one of the biggest fans.
Which flavor do you have in your hand right now?
It's the original chocolate.
Oh, I love that. Simple as that.
Very simple, guys.
Please do enjoy. Let me not hold you back.
Thank you very much.
Catherine, I've just tasted all the flavors, but I have to say, these nuts is my favorite. I'm going to pack up all of these nuts flavors here. I have to ask, I've noticed that, you know, games, Roblox game is number one.
Yes.
How do you plan on integrating Mr. Beast's Feastables into the game?
That was just amazing. So we're very proud of the Roblox game, mm. the game. And it's in the top 0.4% in the world.
Wow.
So it only made perfect sense to put the Feastables into the game. So you heard it here first. Yes. Rush in there and see it on Roblox.
Oh, this is amazing. Thank you so much for giving us insight on your collaboration with Mr. Beast and what we can look forward to. This is delicious. I think I'm just gonna take the entire thing home, right? Bye, Catherine. Thank you. I will enjoy them, definitely. I'm pretty sure you do not want to miss out on this historic moment. Make sure to head on over to your nearest game or even macro store to get your hands on the Mr. Beast Feastable chocolate bars. You want to be a part of this historic moment.
I'm going there straight after the show.
I was about to ask you, have you tried it?
No, I'm going there straight after the show. I'm a huge fan. He's a big inspiration to myself, you know, doing YouTube stuff. So, like, well, I'm so excited that it's actually here in South Africa.
Oh, well, Mr. Beast is certainly killing it. We also even had his girlfriend on the show not too long ago.
You interviewed her on the show. Yes. We have a close connection to it.
Oh, so, yeah. Well, listen, incredible. Well, we still have lots coming up. What's coming up, Wastey?
Now, coming up in your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we meet the cast of an amazing Afrikaans production called Lisa Sirklafir, as well as an incredible hummus, but not just any hummus. It's going to be edamame hummus with Chef Clem a little bit later. Stay right there.
Bespoke.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show Express here at S3. And Grant and I are going to be tracking through some of your answers to this beautiful question is, what's an animation that makes you feel good? So here they come. Thank you so much for jumping in.
So Amy Beat has said Beauty and the Beast.
Lovely.
Like, I think, you know, I get a lot of people really like that.
Yeah.
And Bumakazi said Tom and Jerry. Does Tom and Jerry make you feel good?
I think so. It's quite frantic, but I think maybe it's for some.
Oh, okay, this is for you.
Right.
Vincent Latuli said that SpongeBob SquarePants or Dragon Ball Z. Look, Dragon Ball Z always makes me feel good because I feel like I'm at school and I've got no problems. You know, like my homework's done, I've got no problems. True. You know what I mean?
4 o'clock in the afternoon, yeah, I remember that time. Nick Lombard saying, Sing always makes me feel awesome.
You know, I actually just clicked now. Sing is the movie, the animated movie Sing. I just thought Nick was just like, I want to sing.
Well, you Nick could if you want to send us a little voice note, that's fine. Like Jocelyn did, in fact, answering the question.
A very good morning to my Expresso family. My best favorite animation would be The Barnyard. My all-time favorite, The Barnyard. Thank you so much, Jocelyn Avogadro Spy.
Oh, that is amazing. Thank you so much. Also, let's take a look at some more. All right, we got Queen who's saying Popeye the Spinach Man. Of course, Tom and Jerry. Then Junior Pachi saying Dragon Ball is my therapy.
Yes, I'm with Junior. Dragon Ball Z is definitely my therapy as well.
Lovely stuff. Thanks a lot. Keep on answering throughout the show. We'd love to hear 063-408-8863. Let's take a look at the news headlines. Zoe is standing by.
Thank you, gentlemen. At 7 o'clock, let's look at those national headlines. Northwest MEC for Economic Development, Virginia Hlapi, has issued a stern warning to those selling food items past their expiry date. Hlapi says any harm suffered by consumers due to consumption of expired goods will result in harsh actions. Northwest Education Department said earlier this week that five learners of the Kgolosego Primary School in Ventersdorp had been discharged from hospital after allegedly consuming snacks past their expiry date. And all miners from the Gold One mine in Springs on the East Rand have been brought to the surface. The miners had been underground since Sunday. The Deputy Secretary General of the National Union of Mine Workers, Mpho Pakedi, says a total of 563 miners, including senior management members, had been held hostage by other miners who had demanded that trade union AMCU be recognised by the Gold One mine. No details of the negotiations which took place are available as yet. Moving to news abroad, the United Nations Agency for Palestine Refugees warns that shelters in Gaza's Strip are overwhelmed by uprooted residents. Some 600,000 Palestinians are homeless. This is four times more than the number of people the shelters can accommodate. The agency also warned that its support could not be continued without fuel. The UN's vehicles urgently need fuel to be able to distribute limited emergency supplies. Meanwhile, Israeli PM Benjamin Netanyahu has reiterated that Israel was preparing for a ground invasion of Gaza, but wouldn't say when. And Nigeria has begun a mass vaccination campaign against human papillomavirus, also known as HPV, in a bid to drastically reduce the rate of cervical cancer. HPV, a common virus usually spread through intimate sexual contact, can in a minority of cases lead to cervical cancer. In 2021, a major study found that HPV vaccine was reducing cases of cervical cancer by nearly 90%. The nationwide campaign began yesterday and the Health Ministry aims to vaccinate some 16.6 million girls aged between 9 and 14 by the end of 2025. And for those of us who would like to be active or at least not too inactive, the solution lies in a study by the Shanghai Jiao Tong University School of Medicine. The study found that Tai Chi may help slow down the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Those who practice the martial art, which combines slow, gentle movements with deep breathing and relaxation twice a week, had fewer complications and a better quality of life. The charity Parkinson's UK describes Tai Chi as low-intensity physical activity that can help to lift your mood and help you live well. You can find Tai Chi lessons even online. Well, that's where I leave your morning headlines. Let's take another look at your sports.
Thanks a lot, Zoe. Let's take a look at that sporting action. In a statement from World Rugby, it's confirmed that in the Rugby World Cup final at Stade de France, the Springboks and the All Blacks will sport the iconic uniforms. The Springboks will be in their traditional green and gold jerseys with white shorts and green socks, while New Zealand will be dressed in all black. With six of the nine World Cup titles shared between them, these teams boast remarkable success. It's noteworthy that the Springboks and the All Blacks met in a final just once back in 1995, when the Springboks clinched their first Webb Ellis Cup in Johannesburg's Ellis Park. Now, staying with rugby, Argentina has made adjustments to their lineup for the Rugby World Cup's bronze medal clash against England in Paris tomorrow. Coach Michael Checa has introduced Pedro Rubiolo as well as Thomas Cobelli and Geronimo de la Fuente into the starting 15, emphasizing their commitment to concluding the tournament positively. England's experienced duo of Manu Tuilagi as well as Ben Youngs will also feature in what might be their final England appearances, while Tom Curry is set to make his 50th England appearance. The bronze medal match between Argentina and England is scheduled for tomorrow at 9 p.m. Now on to some cricketing action. Glenn Maxwell's blazing century, what an incredible hit. In just 40 balls, along with David Warner's impressive 104, propelled Australia to a record-breaking 309-run win against the Netherlands yesterday. Australia posted an imposing total of 399 for 8, and their bowlers made quick work of the Dutch, dismissing them for a mere 90 in just 21 overs in New Delhi. This win surpassed Australia's previous record victory, a margin, in the World Cup set against Afghanistan back in 2015 with a 275-run margin. After a shaky start with two losses, Australia has now secured three consecutive wins, solidifying their fourth place in the 10-team table as they aim for the semi-finals. And our very own Banyana Banyana play to a 1-1 draw against the Democratic Republic of Congo in the first leg of the 2024 CAF Women's Olympic Qualifier at Stade des Matières on Wednesday. And of course, DR Congo dominated early, but Kaylin Swart's goalkeeping kept them at bay. Grace Mfuamba scored the hosts, well, for the hosts in the 40th minute. Banyana struggled, but Temi Khatlana's brilliant strike, assisted by Nicole Michael, brought them level in the 48th minute. Banyana Banyana has an edge with an away goal. The DR Congo remains a formidable opponent for the second leg at Orlando Stadium in Soweto. That'll be on Monday, the 30th, 2023. That's it for sport for now. Let's take a look at the roads ahead of you. If you're still on the way to work, here are the details with Zoe.
Thanks, Wasty. Well, let's start off with traffic in Gauteng. There's been an accident on the N12 eastbound at Diepkloof Interchange. The centre lane's closed. Expect delays. And if you're in KZN, there's protest action on the R617 at the Mopani. Avoid the affected area and remain vigilant while driving. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And the fire on the R31 between Hotazel and Kuruman in the Northern Cape was still blazing last night. The spokesperson for the Northern Cape Department of Cooperative Governance, Babalwa Mzambo, says although the fire is contained, they are continuing to monitor the situation. Meanwhile, the Democratic Alliance has called on the Northern Cape government to set up a wildfire task force to investigate the cause of the fires. This as millions of rands worth of damage has been caused in recent weeks. The SA Weather Service have issued a warning that heatwave conditions are expected over Gauteng and parts of the Northwest and the Northern Cape until tomorrow. The dry, hot and windy weather aggravates the occurrences and spread the fires. Well, that's your weather news. Let's take a look at your temperatures. Some hot temperatures all across the country. Well, we love seeing your sunrise view, so let's take a look at this one for this hour. Natalie Peterson shared her view, and this is what she had to say. An early morning walk in Somerset West and the beauty of a sunrise, so beautiful. Well, just looking at those mountains, it looks like a screensaver. So thank you for sharing that. If you would love to share your good morning view with us, do so on our WhatsApp line. It's on your screen right now. That number is 063-408-8863.
After the break, we're going to be meeting the cast of the Afrikaans production, Lisa Sutcliffe here, and we're going to be making an incredible edamame bean hummus with Peter Crisps. This is totally up my alley, Clem, so...
Yeah, but why are you walking around with my magic beans? Could I have my magic beans back? Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We'll see you after the break.
Who's linking to us?
Your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso here at S3, and we love a bit of culture, don't we? We get a chance to meet the stars of an incredible Afrikaans production called Lisa Sir Klavier, and of course Kutle is in Johannesburg with the amazing, incredible team, and I hope that you can support local productions like these. Over to you, Kutle.
Thank you so much, Carl. A very good morning to everyone in studio. Molweni Nonge Emzansi. We are coming to you live from Johannesburg, kicking off the day with something really exciting upcoming. Lisa Sir Klavier is set to take place from the 3rd to the 12th of November at the State Theatre in Pretoria. Now, it features some of your favorite Afrikaans musicians and actors. Listen to this, okay? This one is about a divorcee who is faced with two options. Number one, to flee the country, start all over afresh, or to do one final show and possibly rekindle an old romance. Which one will it be? It's a story about intrigue, love, and hope, and we are joined by some incredible people to give us insight on what we can expect. A very good morning to you. I'm talking Niels, Altes, and Mark Lee. How are you doing?
We're good. It's great to be here.
Espresso. Awesome.
Actually, I wanted to say, goeiemôre, hoe gaan dit?
Goed, dankie.
Dit is julle goed.
Ek gaan baie goed, dankie. Ons hou van die feit dat jy mooi Afrikaans kan praat.
Ah, listen, ek probeer, hoor. Ek try. I'm really excited that you guys are here. Okay, we're going to start off by acknowledging that this is the first time an Afrikaans, you know, theater play is set to take place at the State Theater of this magnitude in such a long time. Why do you think that this is, Marley?
Well, I think as an audience, we have forgotten what it feels like to sit in, you know, to sit in a theater and watch a show. The energy is absolutely amazing. Mm. And I think it's an important job. Mm. And yeah, it's an honor to be the first cast to do it in so long.
Yes.
So hopefully we don't disappoint.
I trust that you will not disappoint, because the play is based on an iconic South African song by Kwes Kombes. Mm-hmm. It's called Lisa Sir Klavier.
Absolutely.
Tell us more about that.
Well, I think it's so iconic that the title Lisa Sir Klavier, to an extent, is almost guaranteed to resonate well with an Afrikaans audience. I cannot think of an Afrikaans-speaking person, young or old, that doesn't know that song. Mm. And it's iconic for a reason. It's a magnificent song. Mm. And it's melancholic, but really kind of takes you. Mm. And so it just kind of made sense to, if you're using Afrikaans songs, well-known Afrikaans songs, to choose one that is that well known as a title, and it just kind of flows off the tongue quite well.
Yes, and people resonate with it. It's nostalgic as well.
Absolutely.
It just takes you to that place, and to bring it forth in a romantic sort of space with music, just out of this world. Altes, have you had your coffee?
Yes, it's a bit early for normally this time we're either on set or we're driving the kids to school.
So yeah.
Normally up this time, but not working specifically this time in the morning.
Well, I'm glad that you're here with us. What makes this production so great to be a part of?
I think we kind of touched on the main subject of Lisa Sir Klavier, the iconic song. I think the main, first and foremost, I think it's the song choices that we've got in the story. Mm. There's classics from, I think, what's from the 60s to like most recent songs. So we've got, obviously, Kwes Kombes, we've got Johannes Kerkorrel, we've got Spoegwolf, we've got Fransje van Cooke, we've got
Garen Zoid.
So it's the whole, it's a tour through the ages with music, and I think that's the main thing. And obviously, the amazing cast we're working with, I think that's the magic of it, and obviously being able to perform in the State Theatre.
And for you, Marie, what makes this such a great production to be a part of?
Definitely the element of a live band, and the fact that both of us are actually playing in the band So it's like it's such a nice challenge. I don't think one would just go and develop the skill, because there's always something else, you know. There's always like kids to pick up and assignments and you know, money to be made. So when you do a production and you get a chance to actually revisit this skill that you've got but you never use, it's really cool. And just to have a band on stage who is part of the story, they're part of the you know, they're part of the cast, they've got lines, and you know, we kind of, there's like a weave of, yeah, it's absolutely amazing.
Oh, that is fantastic. Which instruments do you play?
A little bit of guitar.
Uh-huh. And piano.
Oh, that is lovely.
Yes.
Now, Altus, you play the ex-boyfriend, right? As the audience, how should we feel about this? Do we like you in the story? Do we not like you? Guess closer see to ex on a solvegi. Like, that's just one problematic ex that just won't go away.
I think that's also, I think, a good thing about this, about the whole story. Everyone can relate. I think both of us probably had an ex somewhere in our lives. And yeah, where the story kind of ends, or the backstory where our paths split. So it's been that longing for so many years. You had the love of your life, and the person left, and there were good reasons why she left. So it wasn't a bad breakup. And it's just that yearning and that longing for something's missing. And life goes on, but there's still something missing. And I'm sure everyone can relate to that kind of feeling that you've lost something, and how do I get it back? And then one day, it's back again, and then you kind of don't know, do we jump, do we kind of stay
take
away?
Caution.
Yeah, take caution. So, and that's, I think that's a beautiful part of the story, how that develops from being still angry from back then to getting to the end, which we're not going to give away, but to get to that point of, rekindling lost love.
Hopefully we find the answers when we watch Lisa Seglafir. Neil, just finally talk to us about the details from the 3rd to the 12th of November, State Theatre. Where do we get our tickets?
You go to Web Tickets on the Friday nights. It's 7 o'clock. On both Saturday and Sundays, it's 11 and 3 o'clock, because people seem to be a bit wary to go into any kind of city these days at night. So 11 and 3. Web Tickets, 200 Rand tickets on the Friday, and then 230 to 300 Rand for the other two dates.
Thank you so much for joining us on your Feel Good Breakfast show and just giving us insight on what we can expect. I'm pretty sure you are all brilliant on that stage. I'm pretty sure you know and have found out that this is the perfect date night idea. Make sure to get your tickets, okay? Lisa Seglafir, set to take place from the 3rd to the 12th of November at the State Theatre in Pretoria. Keep it locked, because there's more coming to you live from Johannesburg.
Oh, bye, Dankie Kuchle. I thought you would maybe, you know, finish that off in Afrikaans, Lisa Seglafir, but looking forward to that production.
Oh, yeah, well, my Afrikaans isn't that good, but we'll get over that. It's just over a month until we welcome the summer. It's really nearly here. We're already starting to experience those 30-degree days plus, especially here in Cape Town. And along with the warmer weather, Tropica has been putting out some incredible content on socials to get you pumped up.
Yes, they're getting us pumped up. And we recently visited the Tropica team creating the content. It may not have sounded like the oceans, but the City of Gold has the next best thing.
Tropica has brought together a few of SA's hottest influencers to create some epic content and, of course, enjoy some ice-cold Tropica. He's a successful entrepreneur, model, and all-round golden boy. Louis Manana is one of Namibia's hottest exports.
So for this summer, I intend to do Cape Town, and the beach of my choice is Muizenberg Beach. That's because it's less dense, less people, very beautiful beaches. You can go diving, you know, so yeah.
Professional model and fashionista Nicole Vicker shares tips and tricks on her social platforms to get the best out of your wardrobe. And she knows just how to enjoy summer.
Oh my word, the winter is always too long. Like, it can never be short enough. Today for the Tropica campaign, I'm looking forward to creating really cool, fun, summery content, because summer is finally here.
Juggling life as an influencer and studying to be an engineer, Natanya Vater is all about hard work and looking good while she's at it.
Summertime
time in Joburg is my favorite. We can go to Sun City, the events, the parties, the clubs, everything's pumping. For this summer, I actually do have really big plans. I'm gonna be doing my third year vacation work, and hopefully I'll figure out which field I want to specialize in.
It's super important to just love what you wear. I mean, you know, like keeping up with trends, that's fun and all, but if you absolutely love what you wear, you'll feel confident and that's all that matters.
Between South Africa and Namibia, that's a tough one, that's a tough one. First of all, Namibia used to be a South African colony, so technically we are part of South Africa in a way. But I'd definitely say Namibia, only because we have the oldest desert in the world and it's the only place where the desert meets the ocean and there's a beautiful beach over there, you know.
The past few months, I've been studying engineering at the University of Pretoria and I'm just really busy with my degree as well as social media content. It's quite difficult juggling studies as well as influencing, but I think it's really fun. It's a challenge, and I love a challenge.
Besides enjoying a day out at the pool, there are plenty of activities to keep you engaged in Joburg over the summer months.
Best things to do in Joburg in summer are, I would say, definitely Gold Reef City.
For me, it's definitely Four Ways Market. You know, it's by the lake, there's music, there's food, good vibes. You know, it's summer, so the market's in Four Ways, yeah.
Put me by a pool, cocktail in hand, summer, sun, yes please, I'll be there. Thank you, goodbye. Okay, best place to go in South Africa, I'd have to say Cape Town.
I'm with you on that one, but somewhere far like Mullies Point or Muizenberg Beach, you know, somewhere far where it's not too crowded, where it's still nice. You go deep diving as well, you know. And
okay,
surfing,
I think both of you are very wrong. It's Umhlanga, okay? Uh-huh. It's Durban. The water is warm. Why would you want to go on ice-cold beaches?
You're just biased because you're from KZN. That's
you want to swim on an ice-cold beach, and the vibe's immaculate.
The best part of creating content with product is the fact that you get to consume the product. My highlight was trying the different flavors of Tropica. It's safe to say I have a new favorite drink.
Honestly, today was so exciting. I got to meet great people, try out great flavors of Tropica. If I could do this every single day, it would be the life. There's nothing smoother than a Tropica summer, right? Can't wait for you guys to check this out.
You guys should check out all the content that we created on @mytropica.
Hearing them talk about all of their favorite beaches makes me miss, like, just being at the beach and enjoying the warm weather, wind-free.
Yeah, no, I'm really excited. My favorite beach, I think, I know they said that theirs was Muizenberg and Umhlanga are the best in the country, according to them. But my favorite is Buffelsbaai in Knysna. It's quiet, it's got really warm water, it's out of the way. What's yours?
Oh, I actually don't, anyone that's safe to swim in, like, no, I'm fine and happy with that. But if you want to check out some of the content that was created at the influencer shoot, just head on over to @mytropica on social media, where you will find it all kinds of fun that they've done, like the summer guides, music playlists, and even how you can enhance your way to win some awesome prizes.
Make my day, boy.
Tropica, nothing smoother.
It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and coming up for you, we look at some of the amazing memories from the Rugby World Cup finals, many of which the Springboks have been a part of. And then, of course, the Feather Awards this Pride Month. We need to look into that and celebrate along with them. So make sure you stick around here at your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso and S3.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and we're about to play a fun little game. Now, we all see the success, but often not the hard work that has gone into making a rugby team successful. Since today's Thursday, we thought for this Throwback Thursday, we're going to take a look at the history of our two finalists. I'm talking about the Springboks and the All Blacks in a bit of a game. And this is proudly brought to you by the proud sponsors of the 2023 Rugby World Cup, Total Energies. We also had to bring Lorenzo Durres in to join us for the fun and games against Carl Wastey. Are you ready? Now, the rules are simple. You will each get a question. Okay. In fact, there will be two questions about each of the teams, so that's the Springboks and the All Blacks. You will have 10 seconds to give me your answer, and then each of you will display your answer. We will take a look at who is the winner of that round. So are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Pretty straightforward.
Let's do this.
You have 10 seconds to answer. I will give you a little countdown. How does that sound?
Oh, okay. That's perfect.
Question first, then you're allowed to write your answer. Question number one.
All right.
Who was player of the match in the 2019 Rugby World Cup final that saw the victory of the Springboks over the English rivals? In 3, 2, 1, give me your answer. Well, write it down. You need to write the whole answer down.
Oh, there's A, B, or C there.
Was there A, B, or C?
Yes.
Yes, A, B, or C.
Yeah.
And so the answer is, oh, I didn't see the multiple choice. Let's reveal.
I just wrote C there. Sorry.
There we
Apologies.
Okay, option.
But I feel like we're both wrong.
Really?
Let's see the answer. Let's get the answer on the board. Dwayne from Mielen. Was he number C?
Well done.
Was he
Was he C? No, he was C.
Okay, so well Lorenzo, done, you get that point.
Thank you, Maya. Absolutely amazing in that final.
Okay, there's an A, B, or C. It's multiple choice. Question number two. Let's take a look. Which New Zealand rugby player is known for redefining wing play? Is it A, Ron Jordan, B, Jonah Loma, C, Julian Sevilla? A, B, or C? In 3, 2, 1, write down your answer. If you are done, we will stop the timer.
I wrote it in full now.
Oh, yeah, and I went the other way around.
B, let's see, what is the answer for our question number two?
Oh, it has to be
correct
the legend.
Correct answer, Jonah Lomu.
Ooh. Thank you. That's great. Thanks for giving me a point.
Thanks, gentlemen. Lorenzo,
thanks for helping your brother out.
I'm trying.
You're the best.
Let's get into Robin the third question. Are you ready?
Yes.
Who is the top South African point scorer of all time? Is it A, Percy Montgomery, B, Mornay Steyn, or C, Andre Pollard? Give me their name. Don't write A, B, or C. Give me their name. In 3, 2, 1, whatever, left of the timer. Okay. And show, Percy Montgomery. Let's see who is the all-time.
There you go, Percival.
There you go.
Here we go. Do we know how much?
900, I think it's 937.
Oh, I was going to say 936.
Yeah, about 937, around about there.
And who's second close? Do we know?
Andre Pollard.
Okay.
Andre Pollard, second with about 600, just over 600 points.
Okay, he's got a bit of catching up to do. Okay, next question. Which All Black player kicked the final conversion that led to New Zealand dominating France 29-9? Is it Barry John, B, Grant Fox, or C, Simon Chuane? Kulani. Kulani. Calhane. We will pronounce all those surnames in various ways, like the commentator might say it.
Okay.
Lebeschachne, Lebeschane, so many ways to say it. And the answer is, let's reveal it. Oh, we have two different answers. We've got Grant Fox and...
Here we go.
Okay, so that point goes to Lorenzo.
1987 World Cup final, eh? One penalty and a few conversions.
Well done. Yes, I remember it like it was yesterday.
No.
I feel like Lorenzo studied before he came for this game.
No. Need to watch these games over and over, and I love that about it. It was a good game, especially with France.
He should be Express's sports editor. That'd be amazing.
He should,
yeah, maybe I should.
That'd be fantastic. He's clued up.
Oh, well, listen, well done, Lorenzo. You take the win on this one. Oh, Wastey, you were excellent. I mean, you pointed out there was an A, B, or C. But why don't you get ready for the game festivities with Total Energies? Head on over to a Total Energy service station to top up on fuel, bright charcoal, fire lighters, snacks, and drinks for the big game, and earn club points that can be redeemed for cashback, helping you save on those future purchases.
Just like in rugby, it's uniting our energies that helps us move forward.
All right, so after all that excitement, shoo! I lost, but it's okay because I'm going to win in the kitchen with Chef Clem. Now, innovate your summer snacking every single time. Experience with a burst of freshness and a crunch, which is always good. We're about to bring the beautiful Savannah Spirit to your picnic with our mouth-watering edamame hummus. Up to you, with Peter Crisps. We're not sure who Peter Crisps is, but we'll meet him soon. And every bite becomes an unforgettable adventure. Chef Clem, you need to show us how. First and foremost, right, I want to know, what is your sense of hummus, or hamas, or hummus, right?
I like putting a little bit of the, hummus. But you don't want to make hummus. It too heavy, you just want to make it like hummus.
Hummus, exactly. Hummus. I like hummus as well. I like to do that little bit of texture as well, which is great, so.
But I have never hummused. I've never hummused.
No.
No.
A lot of people do still do that, but hummus. It's, yeah.
No, okay, so.
Hummus, let's go.
This one is for Grant Hines because.
Yes.
It's all plant-based, not a bit of like dairy or meat in it, and the flavors that come through are so delicious. But we're gonna do a swap.
I like to do swap.
And swap.
Let's go.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask you to work on the crispy Peter Crisp.
I can do that. Who's Peter Crisp?
Peter Crisp is an awesome guy.
Sounds like a guy who kicked a penalty in a World Cup final.
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice.
Probably not.
What I need from you, you got pita breads in front of you. I need you to cut them into triangles. And then you've got some olive oil, you've got some dried oregano, you've got some dried basil, you've got some salt, maybe I think that's garlic powder. You're going to just coat all those pita triangles in that seasoning, and then it's going to go to the oven in your magic tray.
And what triangles are we looking for here? You're looking for the smaller triangles, right?
You know what? Actually, I don't want to show you what we've got, because I want you to feel like with your heart, how would you, like...
I'd go in half first.
And then remember, it's also...
I'd go in half again.
It's for dipping, so you can decide how big you want to make it, how small you want to make it.
I'd go across here.
Yes,
And then I'd go like that. That's how I'd do the triangles. And then I'd go here.
Are those isosceles triangles?
No, I'm saying it's balanced, so that everybody gets peace.
Everybody gets a pizza. Okay, so then, for the actual hummus itself, we got some edamame beans. These are really great, amazing, full of protein. And again, also the color. We have to be honest, we also eat with our eyes, so that green's gonna come through. Get those edamames in there, edamame.
There I love edamame, actually, because I think it's so beautiful, and I've also heard about the nutritional value of edamame, too. So it's really, really great. Some good proteins in there, good roughage in there as well.
That's right.
So it's such a great snack. I think if you go to any Asian restaurant, you get some edamame to start off with. There's something beautiful about that, so.
Love the story. Once saw someone order the edamames, and you know they come in those pods.
Oh, no.
Swear
did
I
eat
saw
the whole thing?
She chewed right through the pod, and she was happy with it. But, okay, just at home, so when you do order at restaurants, you got to, like, pop the little edamame beans in your mouth and put the skin back down. Don't be eating the pods. You don't need that fiber. It's okay. It's okay. Right. How you doing there, Carl?
Always well, my brother. Always well. Giving it the treatment that you deserve.
There we go. Tahini's gone in. Maple's gone in. A little bit of olive oil goes in. A little bit of water, and that's just going to thin it down. Those are good. Those smell great. Also, it's a great thing to do with bread that's a little stale, that's just been out for a while. Yes, man. Yes.
Give it a proper coating. That's important. I think this is the fun part of the whole thing, and it just looks great with the herbs and the oil.
It's good. Are you ready for some noise?
Ready. Go. Give me some noise.
Are you okay there, Carl?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. So you're going to probably want to give it a little mix and then add a little bit of water to it. You're gonna go, and now with a little bit of cumin, a little salt and pepper, a little bit of garlic. You like garlic?
Sorted.
Oh, I'm going to put the whole clove of garlic in, okay? And we got some lemon.
Yes.
Okay.
Do that.
There
give
we go.
Lemon.
In. How are you doing there, Carl? It's looking good.
I'm just getting my baking tray ready because we're going to put this into the oven very soon. Great, so.
There we go. Done. I mean, this is a really great snack.
You know, that hummus is, I think it's really great to make on your own. I mean, it's great to purchase from your favorite retail store, but there's something really rewarding about making your own hummus.
Absolutely.
With your own idea and like your own flavors and then put it on the table and it's like, oh, well, where'd you get this from, Carl? It's like, I made it. Ha! Right, these are good to go.
That looks good. Okay, we've got our you got to do like a little hummusy thing, you know what I mean? Like where you kind of like create a little wild, hit it with a little bit of extra olive oil.
I drop some like pine nuts on there.
Yes.
That'd be great.
A little bit of that extra cumin, a little bit of salt and pepper, a little bit of that. herbage. Good, you gotta eat it with the herbage. Yes, some of these Peters. Let me just put them in the middle. In the middle, right there.
Hold on, wait, let's do a swap quickly. I wanna just investigate this thing over here. I actually wanna add a bit more while I do that, right? We're gonna go down with those as well. But the thing is, you know, when it comes to hummus, right? It's not only absolutely delicious, but also it captures the vibrant essence of, you know, Plascon's green grass color for their exhilarating spring savanna color palette, which is obviously something fantastic. And it really inspires growth, it inspires luxury, which is phenomenal. So if you wanna get your hands on this delicious recipe, just head on over to expressoshow.com. This, my friend, is looking fantastic.
Grand Hines would approve.
I hope so. Actually, that's for him. That's, so we made that for him with love. So Grant, hopefully you're going to love this one, though. But that's it. It's beautiful. It really is good. Thank you, man.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful. You've got a great sense of hummus.
When the cracks start to show, our strength and resilience is legendary. Micatex, strong enough to endure anything.
We are getting super excited on your Feel Good Breakfast show ahead of the Feather Awards for Pride Month. We'll be unpacking that, and then we also have Adam joining us for a spectacular performance. So stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. We have this and a whole lot more still on its way.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Expresso, and we've got something very, very, very exciting when it comes to Pride Month happening in Johannesburg.
That's right. We love it when we get to connect with Kuhle live. And the 15th Feather Awards is around the corner, and Kuhle is standing by to give us all of the details we need as we celebrate Pride Month.
Thank you, Colin Zoe. We are back live in Johannesburg. Our guest right now is no stranger to the limelight. He is an entrepreneur and the founder of the Feather Awards. We are about to get into all things Pride and the upcoming 15th Feather Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody, welcome to the Expresso stage. Tami Dish, woo woo.
This is where you're supposed to clap, you know?
Exactly.
The people in Cape Town would be going like that.
We need an audience.
I mean, like, I just bumped into Shudu. Yes. She should be clapping for me right now.
She's busy in makeup. We're going to chat to Shudu a bit. Okay. Tami, good morning. Yeah. Happy Pride Month.
Thank you. Happy Pride Month to you too.
Thank you. I have a question, right?
Yeah.
We celebrate Pride here in South Africa in October,
yeah,
right? Why is it different from the rest of the world?
Well, because people like Simon Ngoli, Bev Ditsi, Phumi Mthethwa decided at some point with GLOW, which was a movement that came out of Wits, that they wanted to start their first Pride in on the 13th of October in 1990. So 33 years in,
wow.
we celebrate Pride in October because it's such a significant thing. But also, I mean, we South Africa and we the hope of the continent, and where we should be actually celebrating Pride 365
yes.
days a year. Internationally, of course, it's June because that's when, you know, Stonewall happened and that's when they celebrate their stuff. But we found ways to move it around. Certain countries celebrated at different points and different times of the year.
That is truly
yeah.
significant. Why do you think it's important for everyone to participate and celebrate Pride Month?
Why do I think it's important? Because I think that inclusivity is important. I think that visibility is important. I think that the protection of humans is important. But also I think that people should just like support queer people
yes.
and support them financially
yes.
and support all queer businesses. But yeah, I think it's really just to say we're here, we're queer, and we're not going anywhere. I mean, you've seen everything else that's been happening across the continent. There are quite a couple of pushbacks. We keep dealing with refugees that are, you know, coming to the country because we're a safe space. And, you know, there are people out there who continue to fund hate. So Pride must happen so that we can show them that we will find ways to fund love.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And one way of celebrating Pride Month, right,
yeah.
is the Feather Awards, I believe. Take us back to 15 years ago.
Oh, my God.
I love
God.
The story. Yes. How the Feather Awards started. Tom.
At Groove. They started at Groove. No, but honestly, like on the corridors of the ACBC, mm-hmm. There used to be like an award show. I started partying like very early in my life. I attended like the Dugu Dugu Awards, and then when those got canned, Joe and I decided we need to do something and start an award ceremony for queer people.
Mm.
At that point, it was just for us to spark dialogue between people talking about what is this LGBTQIA plus award ceremony. And we successfully managed to get people, you know, the buzz. I remember our first part of our nominees, we nominated Julius. As Drama Queen of the Year,
yes.
like in our first year, and he was the first person to say, I'm not a drama queen and all those things, and literally in 2 days, everybody knew what feathers were, and they were interested in finding out more about it. So over years, we've grown. We run workshops, we run dialogues, we run intervention programs for communities, we do a lot of sensitization training, we're in transformation spaces, both in the public and the private sector. We've also done like many things. I mean, through Feathers and the Tammy Desh Foundation, I mean, like this entire Pride Month has been incredibly amazing. We've got a show starting tonight
Ooh.
At the Market Theatre House of Pink, Volume 3. We're part of a soccer team, Tammy Desh Football Club for Puti's Legacy Games. There's Pride on Saturday happening. There've been like a series of things. Soweto Pride has happened. So there's just a lot of things that are happening to celebrate just who we are. So it's a very big weekend
yes.
Leading up to the Feather Awards that are happening on the 9th of November at the Market Theatre.
You know what? I think you are so incredible, Tammy, and so impressive.
You think?
I know. Because you were only 23 when the Feather Awards started. After 15 years, what are some of the challenges do you think you've had, well, have you had to overcome? Because
yeah.
it wasn't easy.
I mean, I think I still go through the same challenge I did when I was 21, trying to find funding for Feathers. A lot of people come into the platform because they think it's sexy and it's stunning and it's beautiful and it's this big glitz and glamour kind of event, but they don't know the work that goes in, you know, throughout the entire year. It's a whole year long process, and we're still continuing to do stuff. The challenges is always funding, and I think it's a bigger conversation. It's not really about just the feathers. It's really about supporting queer people across economically, and also making sure that there's enough funds set aside for us to be able to action and to execute some of the programs that we need to run throughout the year. So, yeah, those have been the challenges. I mean, other than that, it's people who, you know, people will always say, no, I don't think that one should be in that category. I don't think that one should be there. Why are they there? They're not queer, you know, and our job is not to literally out people and to be, you know, to exclude people from the process. We're inclusive and we've created that space for it.
I absolutely love that. Now, what can we expect from the upcoming 15th annual
First of all,
yes,
we're honoring our Simon Goli recipient this year is King Ta, Thandiswa Mazwai. Yes, so she's going to be on stage. You're expecting Zoe Modiga, Langa Mavuso, Buhle Mendalo, Zama Jobe Monet, Thandi Nduli, Mix Blouse, Chaya, Mr. Olivet. I mean, we're talking, it's going to be like, it's a show. We always put on a show. You know, thankfully to our sponsors who continue to support us. So shout out to them. And yeah, we're having a great one. It's our 15th year.
Yes, that's big.
It's also our last year that we're having it as a private function because people have been complaining. So we are going to open it up for people to actually participate and buy tickets. I think that there are more queer people being birthed on a daily basis.
And they need recognition.
And they need space.
Yes. Tammy, thank you so, so much. It's the 15th. Yeah. Number 15 is big. Well done to you and your team. And I'm pretty sure you are going to pull it off. Thank you for joining us.
Ah, thank you for having me. Where's the egg?
Where is the egg?
And the bacon.
Okay.
Okay, we're done.
Just now, okay? The 15th annual Feather Awards upcoming on the 9th of November at the Johannesburg Theatre. We are going to be missing out because that's not my tiki-ti.
No, you're coming.
Do not go anywhere because we are still coming to you live from Johannesburg. About to speak to Miss South Africa 2020 Shudu shortly. Don't go anywhere.
We are not going anywhere, Kuhle. You are looking so fabulous, but we are also joined by someone equally as fabulous. Taking the Espresso stage is Adam the Glamour Clown, and she has been a staple entertainer in the South African drag scene for several years, breaking numerous glass ceilings for drag entertainers and forging a remarkable mainstream drag scene. Can we welcome Adam? Good morning.
Everybody say hi, Adam.
Let's do that again.
Okay, cool. Everybody say, hi, Adam!
Hi, Adam!
Oh, man, there the production value at the function is so great.
We'll warm them, we'll wake them up. We need more coffees around here.
Exactly that.
Oh, it's so lovely to have you here.
It is so amazing to be here, y'all. I am so excited to be here. Honestly, besides the human rights violation of getting a drag queen in full drag at 7 a.m. I'm living. I'm so happy to be here. Gotta give y'all the energy.
Yeah, you're definitely bringing the energy as well as the looks. Can we just talk about this dress?
This is leather. Thank you. Yes, it is by Double T Designer. She is absolutely amazing. She's worked with Richard Nisi. We did a whole bunch of stuff and we worked on this. I am so ecstatic about all the aesthetics that we're giving today. I'm loving it.
Oh, well, you have been doing some incredible things on the local and international scene. So let's focus on the local scene. Being on Seven Delon.
Right.
How was that for you?
That was amazing. Can I tell you, like, just when I ran into the person who was basically saying, like, you're going to be on. You're going to do it. We haven't had a drag queen on. We're going to do that. I was like, that is unreal. It's unreal for me to fathom just, like, you know, the decision to, like, become a drag queen and become a drag entertainer in South Africa is quite a tough one because you're not guaranteed a lovely income. You're not guaranteed anything like that. And, again, like you mentioned, like, breaking a glass ceiling is so important, like, for South African television at large.
Yes.
Just you guys having me here. You know, you guys always historically have had drag queens and stuff. It's amazing. And, like, that was an opportunity that I think really allowed a lot more space for drag on South African TV.
I love that. And you know what? We are here for it. Tell me, how's your Afrikaans? Because you know, Seven Delon's all about the subtitles.
I don't think in Afrikaans.
Okay.
I'll understand it if y'all are going to spring, like, you know, ladende bedrijvende forum on me right now. Trappen van vergelijking at the function. I don't know if I'll ace it, but I'll know Stompy. I'll hit her up. My good girl Stompy. Yeah, we go way back.
We all go back to grade one with Stompy sentence structures. But Adam, you've also had the opportunity to be on a global stage. What's that been like for you, being able to perform and attend events that's you know, is part of the international community?
It's
mind-blowing. Can I tell you, the first time that I got to work with, it's like my heroes. You see these people on TV when you're like a young queer person, you see them on TV, and you're kind of like, wow, this is where we want to be. And then just one day, it happened. And I was at the airport fetching someone that I like looked up to for my entire life, being like, hi, it's me. I'm wearing these like fun thrifted shoes so that you'd comment on them. Like, I can't wait to do this. And since then, it's just kind of snowballed into something amazing. I've met so many icons and heroes in my community. It's been so amazing. Everything is great. Everything's coming up good.
Well, listen, you've got that good energy. You are here right now.
Gotta do it.
We want to hear Adam, the drag clown, the glamour clown perform.
Both.
But it's Adam, the glamour clown. There we go. With Part of Your World by Jodie Benson. Are you ready to take the stage?
Baby, are you?
I am.
Okay, good.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's Adam, the glamour clown.
Thank you.
Look at this stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around you, you'd think, well, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet, right. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down a, what's that word again? A street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. Wandering free, wish I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? I bet you on land they understand that they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stay. And I'm ready to know what the people know. I'm asking my questions to get some answers, like what's a fire and why does it, what's the word burn? When's it my turn? Wouldn't I love to explore that shore up above, out on the sea? Wish I could be part of that world.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. My name is Grant Hines, and if you were here before the break, you'll understand the impact that Adam made on all of us. We were just cheering. It was wild. Adam, when is the show happening?
Babes, we have two shows. So it is a lovely tour. We are going to be in Menlyn on Sunday the 29th of October. We are going to be at the Menlyn Barnyard Theatre. And in Cape Town at 2 p.m., we are going to be at the Homecoming Theatre. You guys can get your tickets on Quicket. Quicket is the doll and the diva. And just generally, we're going to be on tour. So come see us for drag brunch. Come see us everywhere.
Listen, I've followed you on Instagram, so I'm going to be on all night. But it's 8 o'clock now, so it's time for the news.
Oh, thank you. Well, let's start off with those national headlines. Retired SAPS Brigadier Jaap Burger will be summoned to appear before Parliament's Standing Committee on Public Accounts, known as SCOPA, on 15 November in connection with investigations into Eskom. Former Eskom CEO André de Ruyter reported his corruption allegations to Burger after extensive investigations. Burger had in the past twice failed to appear before SCOPA. SCOPA's chairperson says he urges Burger not to undermine Parliament and the Constitution as a legal servant by not appearing. And staying with our local news, the Northwest MEC for Economic Development, Virginia Tlapi, has issued a stern warning to those selling food items past their expiry date. Tlapi says any harm suffered by consumers due to consumption of expired goods will result in harsh actions. Northwest Education Department said earlier this week that all five learners of a primary school in Ventersdorp had been discharged from hospital after allegedly consuming snacks that were past their expiry date. And moving to news abroad, a type of bacterium never seen before in wild elephants has been found in the bodies of six African savannah elephants that died in mysterious circumstances in Zimbabwe. Scientists think the cause of it was a septicemia or blood poisoning that killed the animals in 2020. The findings were published in the journal Nature Communications. The study may also provide further clues concerning the sudden deaths of 356 elephants in neighboring Botswana in the same year. The mysterious deaths of the Botswana elephants made international headlines. Staying with news beyond our own borders, the United Nations Agency for Palestine Refugees warns that shelters in the Gaza Strip are overwhelmed by uprooted residents. Some 600,000 Palestinians are homeless, this four times more than the number of people that the shelters can accommodate. The agency also warned that its support could not be continued without fuel. The UN's vehicle agency need fuel to be able to distribute limited emergency supplies. Meanwhile, Israeli PM Benjamin Netanyahu has reiterated that Israel was preparing for a ground invasion of Gaza, but wouldn't say when. Bringing it back home, Cape Town's V&A Waterfront Marina has, for the fifth year running, been awarded blue flag status for excellence in safety, amenities, cleanliness, and meeting environmental standards. Eight city beaches have also been awarded blue flag status by the Wildlife Environmental Society of South Africa. V&A Waterfront Head of Communications, Donald Cow, said this recognition talks to their commitment to tourism, but also to the preservation of the marine ecosystem at the V&A Waterfront environment, as it is also very much a working harbour. The iconic blue flag is one of the world's most recognised voluntary eco-labels awarded to beaches, marinas and sustainable boating tourism operators. Well, that's where I leave your morning headlines. Let's take a final look at your sport.
Thanks a lot, Zoe. Let's take a look at your sporting action and wrapping things up. Rugby. Now, let's start there. In a statement from World Rugby, it's confirmed that the Rugby World Cup final at Stade de France, the Springboks and the All Blacks will sport their iconic uniforms. The Springboks will be in their traditional green and gold jerseys with white shorts and green socks, and while New Zealand will play in, of course, All Black. With six of the nine World Cup titles shared between them, these teams boast remarkable success. It's noteworthy that the Springboks and All Blacks met in a final just once back in 1995 when the Springboks clinched their first Webb Ellis Cup in Johannesburg's Ellis Park. Now let's stay with rugby. Argentina has made adjustments to their lineup for the Rugby World Cup's bronze medal clash against England in Paris. That'll be tomorrow. Coach Michael Checa has introduced Pedro Rubiolo as well as Thomas Cobelli and Geronimo de la Fuente into the starting 15, emphasizing their commitment to conclude this tournament positively. Now England's experienced duo of Manu Tuilagi as well as Ben Youngs will also feature in what might be their final England appearances, while Tom Curry is set to make his 50th England appearance. The bronze medal match between Argentina and England is scheduled for tomorrow at 9 p.m. Now, cricket, some fireworks there. Glenn Maxwell's blazing century in just 40 balls, along with David Warner's impressive 104, propelled Australia to a record-breaking 309-run win against Netherlands yesterday. Australia posted an imposing total of 399 for 8, and their bowlers made quick work of the Dutch, dismissing them for a mere 90 in 21 overs in New Delhi. And this win surpassed Australia's previous record victory margin in the World Cup, of course, set against Afghanistan in 2015 with a 275-run margin. After a shaky start with two losses, Australia has now secured three consecutive wins, solidifying their fourth place in the 10-team table as they aim for the semi-finals. And wrapping with some football, Banyana Banyana played to a 1-1 draw against the Democratic Republic of Congo in the first leg of the 2024 CAF Women's Olympic Qualifier at Stade des Martyrs on Wednesday. That was just yesterday. DR Congo dominated early, but Kaylin Swart's goalkeeping kept them at bay, and Grace Mfwamba scored for the hosts in the 40th minute. Banyana struggled, but Temi Khatlana's brilliant strike, assisted by Nicole Michael, brought them level in the 48th minute. Banyana Banyana has an edge with an away goal, but DR Congo remains a formidable opponent for the second leg at Orlando Stadium in Soweto on Monday. That is it for the sport for now. Let's take a look at your traffic.
Thank you, Wasty. Let's start off with traffic in Germiston, Johannesburg. There's a vehicle broken down, in fact, a truck on the N3 northbound. It's after the Galulis interchange. The left lane is closed. Drive carefully. In Cape Town, there's been an accident. It's on the N1 outbound after Marine Drive. The left lane is currently closed. Staying in Cape Town, there's some congestion on the N2 outbound before Victoria Road. There are delays, and add some extra travel time to your journey. That's your traffic. Let's take a final look at your weather. And the South African Weather Service has warned that the heat wave conditions resulting in persistently high temperatures are expected in places over Gauteng and the eastern parts of the northwest until tomorrow. Johannesburg Emergency Services have urged residents to take precautions against the heat. Residents are urged to stay hydrated, drink large quantities of water, and stay out of the direct sunlight between 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. in the afternoon. Meanwhile, extremely high fire danger conditions are once again expected over the western and central interiors of the Northern Cape, the western parts of both the Free State and the Northwest provinces, as well as over the Beaufort West and Laingsburg municipalities in the Western Cape. Let's take a final look at your temperatures for your Thursday. Brace yourself, 42 degrees Celsius, that is your high for today. Let's take a look at our final sunrise view for this hour. Naeem Chetty from Bloemhof sent through this photo saying, good morning from Bloemhof Dam. Perfect day for fishing. It brings back so many memories of spending time with my family. Well, Naeem, thank you for sharing this photo and enjoy your time at the Bloemhof Dam. And if you would love to share your good morning view, do so on 063-408-8863.
And coming up in your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we catch up with Miss Essay and give you the perfect recipe for a smash burger, caramelized onions, and brioche buns. It's going to be fun. Stick around.
To the brave hearts who persevere against all odds, we salute you. Along with Adcock Ingram OTC, sponsors of Brave, we're inspiring hope across South Africa this Hopetober. Stand a chance to win 1,500 Rand cash every weekday by answering the weekly Hopetober competition question on Expresso's Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram pages throughout the month of October using hashtag Hopetober and hashtag sponsors of Brave. T's and C's can be found on ExpressoShow.com.
Been a busy show, but an exciting one. Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on S3.
And we have some royalty for you. We've got Miss SA, who is standing by with Kuhle, who is another future Miss SA, in my opinion. And they're going to have a quick catch-up, which is going to be fantastic. So make sure you stick around and wait for this. Kuhle is with Miss SA.
And we are back coming to you live from Johannesburg with someone who does not need much introduction, but I'll introduce her anyways. Miss South Africa 2020, she is a mental health advocate and a published author. Shudupadzu Musida joins us to talk all things about her latest offering, I Am Shudu, Finding My Voice, Knowing My Strength. Good morning, Shudu.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Looking so radiant, but shame you were saying you're tired of working. Right?
Yeah, I'm very tired, but I'm very fulfilled in the work that I'm doing. Mm. So yeah, it's always that thing where you get up and you go, knowing that you have a purpose to fulfill, you know?
Absolutely, and that's what we appreciate about you and how you pour your heart out, you know, and your authenticity into the work that you do. Please tell us more about I Am Shudu, Finding My Voice, Knowing My Strength.
Ah, oh, it's I don't know, it feels like a breath of fresh air for me, mm-hmm. Because it's an offering that speaks, that was very therapeutic to work on. It speaks about bravery, identity, bullying, forgiveness, the bond of friendships, the power of community, but also the power of the voice. Mm. I often feel like children are excluded from the seat at the table, which is something that we often do, trying to shield them and protect them, but they're going through so much, and they just need to have a seat at the table to speak about the issues that face them, but also for us to prepare them to build the world and shape the world that they want to see. But if we don't empower their minds, if we don't give them the right information, and also promote literature that matters, you know, and let them read for meaning, it's almost futile. So this book is to make sure that when they do read, they're reading about things that affect them, so they can be part of the conversation in order to change it and not normalize bullying, not normalize abuse, but actually rebel against it.
I absolutely love that, which leads me to my next question, right? Why is it important, truly, to have the conversation directly with the children at the table?
It's important because they know so much. By the age of 6 or 5, they're already absorbing what you're saying in the house. So children, I believe that children are like sponges. They can repeat exactly what you've said. So why do we not give them the right information to repeat? No, consent, you get me? No, I don't like the way you're treating me. If we give them the right languaging around mental health specifically, and what they like and what they do not like, you're building a nation of empowered children, specifically girls, because they lose their bodily autonomy from the moment they're born because of how societal structures are. So I write these books to make sure that mental health education, one, is a priority. The languaging around how they should be treated is a priority. But also, when you give them a seat at the table, they are now empowered enough to want to know more about the things that affect them. But if you exclude them from the social challenges that they're facing, bullying specifically, you are, it's detrimental to them.
Yeah.
I didn't have conversations about bullying. I normalized it in my head, but it really affected my mental health and how I look at myself and my identity now. It's taken a lot of work for me to look at myself and realize that I am enough and there was nothing ever wrong with me. But if you don't get affirmed in that way, if you don't have those conversations, you'll never know better.
Yeah. Would you say through writing these books, because this is your second children's book, right? You're speaking to a younger self?
Yes, I believe people ask me, who's the book for? It's for children aged 6 to 10 years old, but I also believe it's for the inner child, all our inner children. We all have things that we wished we knew, you know, like certain things that we wish people spoke to us about. And when I was writing this book, it felt like I was speaking to my inner child. I was speaking to Abby, who needed someone to tell her that, you know what, it's okay, you're not alone. You're more than enough, you're beautiful, there's nothing wrong with you, and your difference does not make you weird. It actually makes you stand out and it makes you unique in your own way. But if you don't have those conversations, like, who's gonna have them with us, you know? And now that we're older, we're learning so many things. How many of us right now as adults learn things that we wished we learned as children?
Yes.
There's so much of that. How many of us wish we were affirmed as children to know that we're enough, we're beautiful, and what we have to bring to the table is more than enough, and we deserve the seats at the table. But especially as women as well, we still have the imposter syndrome of wondering if we're good enough, and that's just across the board. So with these books, it was therapeutic for me because it felt like I was healing my inner child. I got to be emotional about the things that I had gone through, but also very proud that I'm on the other side of it. Yeah.
Beautiful. It sounds therapeutic.
Thank
you. You know, and as you've mentioned, a lot of us navigate our way through life thinking that we're not enough, that there's so much out there that we need to do in order to be just fine and to kind of give ourselves that confirmation, Ubana, I am who I am, and I am enough. So you're speaking to a lot of us as well as adults, in as much as it is a children's book. Shudu, I think that this offering is absolutely incredible. It releases on the 8th of November, right?
The 8th of November. It's going to be at all good bookstores around South Africa, and I'll be doing a few launches or in-person appearances and signings at different exclusive bookstores around the country. So I'm very excited for that. And I'm also very excited to interact with children. That's like my favorite thing because I'm like, oh, you know a lot. Okay, cool. I don't have anything to teach you, but you're teaching me.
Yes. Yeah. I love that. Shudu is not going anywhere. She's still right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Find your voice and pre-order her book, I Am Shudu, Finding My Voice and Knowing My Strength. We're about to chat to her about her incredible partnership partnership with Woolworths as she co-founded a swimwear line.
Yes.
By women, for women. You do not want to miss out. Keep it locked. Back to you guys in studio.
Thanks, Kutle.
You know, this makes me feel so self-conscious. You're talking about swimming costumes, and here I'm like dying over this toasted cheese.
It doesn't matter. I feel like swimming costumes and bread, they mix together well. That's fine.
Well, listen, it's not every day one can go our way, but we have something to lift your spirits right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
And spirits will indeed be lifted. You could be one of 7 lucky viewers who walk away with a 1,000 Rand. That is the cash prize. Simply reply to the competition post or question on the Expresso Facebook, Instagram, or X pages, of course, formerly known as Twitter, and tell us what your go-to load shedding sandwich is.
Aha, well, like we love a good toasty ham. Can you help me instead of
That's, let me just give some more. Anyway, what do we say? So X entrance must share the post, right? Not fumble it, share it. And for all the platforms, all right, and make sure that you don't forget to include hashtag MyPerfectAlbany. Competition closes weekly every Friday at 10 a.m. T's and C's can be found on expressoshow.com. And as you know, you can feel the freshness with Albany, the perfect bread for an imperfect world.
You know what? It happens. That's how I cook. We get, you know, you laugh at me.
I'm just saying, it's great. Thank you.
There. Right, the perfect bread. That one will be yours. Yes. How's that?
No, I like the, I want the dropped one.
Just for you.
Look, Carl, you're going to have the dropped one because, you know, you've got to be a gentleman about it. You can't just be the cause of that and not eat it. Anyway, we've got some really exciting things that are happening after the break. Coming up, we're going to be making smash burgers with brioche buns and caramelized onions. And, of course, we're going to have a real big competition around guess the recipe, the braai essentials, the price of the braai essentials. That's coming up. I don't think I'm going to do very well in it. If you are the shopper in the house, you'll know. Find out if your partner's there, and you can bash them now. This is the time to do that. We'll catch you after the break.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. This is your feel-good breakfast show. It's Expresso. And it's time for a little bit more fun and games because this coming Saturday, I think it's one of the biggest games going to take place. South Africa will take on New Zealand in the Rugby World Cup final. And I have no doubt that the entire nation will be celebrating with a braai. But before we light those fires, how about we take a look at how much our favorite braai essentials cost? It's time to find out in another round of Guess the Price. Are you gentlemen ready?
We are going to try.
So how it's going to happen is we're going to pop the items on, we are using the average price. So I know some places are a bit more expensive, yes. Others a bit cheaper. If you find it cheaper, you're always in luck. So are you ready?
Ready.
For the first item, classic beef boerewors, 500 grams. How much do you think that goes for?
So just a disclaimer, I don't eat meat. So I'm gonna be at a little bit of a disadvantage here, but the last time I bought boerewors, which was like 10 years ago, I'd say this should be like 25 rand.
I'm gonna say
per kilogram or just in general?
That's 500 grams, half a kilo.
What?
The last time I bought was like 10 years ago.
I'm gonna say it's about 69.
69 rand?
Okay, let's see. Oh my gosh, let's see. What is the answer?
Is that the price for what?
That is the price of classic beef boerewors, 500 grams. Be glad you're a vegan.
Yeah, you'd be glad you're vegan.
Because this is going to shock you. Let's move over.
You know, like my dad would have that one. That's just his.
500 grams.
And that's one of 20 meats on the plate.
Oh my goodness. Oh my. Okay, well, he'll probably add some free range, keyword free range, lamb rib chops, 500 grams. How much do you think that goes for?
80 rand?
Yeah, 89.
I think 120.
89.99.
It's half a kilogram, hey?
Let's see. It's free range. You always pay more for free range. Let's see. And the answer is 135.
You're down. Are you cryptic?
Wow.
No, I don't have the prices in front of me.
That's great.
135 rand. You're paying for free range.
And then wait, there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces there.
That's great,
Yes. Price of food is expensive.
Those chickpeas are looking good right now.
Okay, this is going to be...
edamame bean hummus.
Okay, gentlemen, how does 6 beef sirloin steaks, so this is a bulk buy, of 1.7 kilograms go for?
279.99.
If I may play to, I think, closer to 330.
Like that.
Mm. How much weight is this?
1.7 kilograms.
Oh, wow, so it's nearly 2 kilograms.
Okay.
I think the...
I think 1.5 grand?
359.
Oh, sorry. 150.
Okay, final answer.
150 rand.
359.
330. Let's go. What's
300. What?
Wow. I was close.
You were very close.
326.76.
So he's cribbing.
Wow.
I'm not cribbing.
But yeah, that is actually what you're going to expect to pay. Mm.
That's like, that's a huge chunk. That's like over a quarter of 1,000 rand.
I love playing this with a vegan. I love that we have all these meat options for the vegan. It's so like, you're like, oh, I'm saving so much.
This is wild. How do people survive?
You're saving the environment and you're saving on your wallet. Yes.
Just get go check out Clem's recipe that we did today on the show. It was the bomb.
Crazy.
Oh, okay. How much do you think Portuguese peri peri butterfly chicken costs?
1.3 kgs.
Yeah. It's a pack. It's a standard pack.
It's a pack. Okay. A butterfly. So it's a spatchcock chicken. Okay, cool. So I'd say about 100 bucks.
Wastey?
140.
I say 120. Let's see. What's the answer?
What?
147. Yeah. Okay, Wastey's closest.
Oh.
Food's
expensive. That used to be like, I remember it used to, a spatchcock chicken used to be about like 80 bucks.
Mm.
Yes.
You're making yourself sound old, but meanwhile, you're just vegan. You've
been
enjoying... I just
haven't eaten it for...
Okay. I'm expecting you to get this one correct, because how much do you think vegan minced soy patty rounds cost?
Oh, there we go.
Okay, average price, because this is also a fluctuation. Yes.
That one.
Oh, these are really good. I love these ones. I rate this is about 60 bucks, 70 bucks? I'll say 70.
I was going to go 80.
How many are in this?
I was going to go 80, but I'm going to go 90 for the sake of that. 90 bucks.
Okay, let's see. What is the price?
50, yeah.
Oh, 52. It's so much cheaper to be vegan.
But they, you need to try those. Those are really good.
Yeah,
they taste
this
so
range,
good.
Yeah, this range at Willy's is great.
Oh, how about garlic butter baguette?
I like how you say baguette.
Baguette. We're going to be getting it.
30 bucks?
30 bucks? Yeah, I'm also thinking 30 bucks.
Yeah, I was gonna go for
29.99.
41.99.
35. Let's see.
What?
What? For bread? I'm sorry.
That was the most genuine, visceral response. For bread?
that honestly, I feel like we are echoing our parents when we finish up with them now.
What? For shoes?
Okay, I'm going to be way off here because I'm never in charge of buying the bag of charcoal, but 4 kilograms. Price of 4 kilograms charcoal.
Oh, this is like, I think about 50 bucks, 80 bucks.
79.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is about, yeah.
It's 4 kgs, it's about 80 bucks.
It's 100 bucks. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay.
94, 95. Okay. Fire starters. I use a lot of these.
Yes. Yeah.
Also, you get the organic ones now, too. Yes, but those are 3 fire starters only.
Yeah, this is a 3-pack, though. This one is 35 rand.
No, this is $24.99.
$45. $24.99. Just because
$99.
Life's expensive. No.
Yeah.
That's the cheapest thing
goodness,
here.
I'm so glad.
That's like the price
you
of
can't
a bag.
Eat it.
Okay. Please don't.
Okay, now let's quickly just, if that had to be your grocery list. So yes. Imagine, Grant, I know this is not your type of food, you're vegan, but you're hosting a brunch, some meat eaters coming along. We put all of that in the trolley. What do you think the total cost of your trolley is going to be? The grand total of all those items we just looked at.
It'd be like 1-2.
Wasty? This is you hosting a bribe. How many people would eat?
I'll go 1,300 rand.
Okay.
Yeah.
I go 1,400. Let's see.
All right.
Total price of our trolley. Under 1,000 rand.
Oh, that's great.
See, now it doesn't seem so bad.
Carl's like, that's great. That's the same price as Spider-Man on PlayStation.
Yes.
Copy of FIFA. Mm-hmm.
Well, listen, don't let prices hold you back when it comes to the braai. With the proudly green Nedbank My Goals account, you're always guaranteed to score with cash back no matter where you shop or what you buy. Now, to find out more about the My Goals account, you can visit netbank.co.za.
Check this. This MyGoals Plus account gives you cash back on groceries and 25 cents back per litre at BP. That's lit.
Lit in 2023. I wonder.
Oh, listen, it's a mad dash here, but it's always so exciting being back in this beautiful kitchen. And over the course of the week, we have unpacked Woolworths as a destination for everything beef mince. Now, they only use selected cuts, never scraps to make their mince, and the quality of their mince is always consistent, which makes it possible by their specialized equipment. Now, we have Chef Clem. He is here to make us a delicious smash burger with caramelized onions on a brioche bun.
On a brioche bun.
We love making burgers at home. That's become such a staple in our house. I try do the mince patties from scratch, but I want to learn from you how to make a smash burger.
Yeah, so what you're going to start off with is the mince, of course. So what I've done is, let's actually just do it. So
we've got lean beef mince that we are going with.
We're going to go with the lean beef mince. So what we're going to do is we're going to shake them into balls, not patties.
Not patties. Okay?
So get a ball, and then you don't want to squish it too much.
Okay, because that squishes the moisture out of
it. Right, and also you just don't want to change the texture of it, so I just give it like one gentle little...
Like a little nudge.
There we go. That's all I need to do. That's the ball.
Okay.
So, I've got some balls that I shaped off already. Use a bigger pan, and you'll always see you can never really do four burgers at a time unless you've got a really big pan, two max. We're going to just do one for the demonstration today.
Okay.
Put your ball down, and you're just going to leave it there for a bit, okay? In the meantime, we're going to come over to you, Zoe. You're going to make our little burger sauce.
Okay.
We got some mayonnaise, some mustard, and tomato sauce. Now, we're using...
Can I mix them all together?
All of it. We're using Dijon. If you're feeling a little spicy, go with the English. It's okay. Add the bowl to the mix as well. It's okay. English mustard is quite nice because it adds a little bit of heat, and it just kind of brightens all the flavors in the sauce as well. And you can add some chopped pickles in as well.
Ooh, yeah, some texture.
Yeah, absolutely. So, the thing about a smash burger is I see people smashing more than once.
Okay.
You can only smash once. So, if you smash more than once, what you're doing is just squeezing the juices out of the burger. So, what I've done is I've put the burger, the ball, down in the pan. And as soon as you see the fat starts spraying out of the patty, like around itself, you know you're good. Another reason I'm doing this is because I really want to get a crust on that burger patty. So you see there, it's starting to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So also don't do that at home. Don't be picking hot stuff out of the pan.
Okay, so don't do what Clem just did.
Do as I say, not as I do.
That's not the way we do it, but anyway.
Baking paper, not wax paper.
Baking paper. There's a difference. Wax paper catches...
Yes.
Catch light.
And that wax coating will come off and the paper will break. Baking paper is a little more resilient to it. So you put your baking paper over, you get your spatula, put your spatula down, and you get your smooshing thing.
That you do the mashed potatoes with.
Yeah. Or a mug or whatever. All you're going to do is just kind of squish it down.
One smash.
This is the only time you can smash.
Okay.
What I'm doing now is
just flattening it.
Yes. Once you've done this, and turn it over, you can't smash anymore.
Okay.
You're just gonna squeeze all those juices out. So the reason we smash is because we want to create as much surface area of the patty with the pan itself.
Okay.
So let me take it off.
So just to clarify, you said you can't smash more than once, but you did it multiple times because it's on the same side.
On the same side.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So once it's flipped, you cannot smash it. Okay.
Smash
once. So you're allowed to push down multiple times if it's on the one side.
Yes.
Just to clarify. Because in my mind, when you said you can't smash more than once, I thought I'd just one push down.
So I will rectify that. You can only smash on one side.
Only one side.
Smash one side, pass.
Okay.
There we go.
Chef Clem, I added the tomato sauce to this mixture. Was that part of the plan?
Yes.
Okay.
You're doing amazing there. Okay, so salt and pepper goes down. There we go. That's going to do its thing. Then we can start assembling. So I'm going to ask you if you can go down with your burger sauce on the base of your buns. And these are brioche buns from the Willy's Bakery. Ah! So good, so good.
You have the ultimate in when it comes to visiting Woolworths. I remember when we were looking at the potatoes, you went to the farm. You also got to visit the factory and, you know, with the processing of the mince. What was the highlight for you taking away from that experience?
I know that mince is such a, what's the word I can use? Such a simple ingredient, right?
It's versatile.
It's versatile. And it's what blew my mind is how much technology and innovation goes behind just producing the mince. It is a silly amount of technology, and it's amazing. Also, the fact that with the computer systems, they can tell to the degree of a percentage how much fat is in that mince. So when you're buying lean mince,
you know
that's what you're getting. Also, mince is not made out of, like, leftover scraps, whatever's left over.
I thought it was.
These are made out of proper quality round cuts. And to see those big cuts of beef go into what goes into the mince, I was really impressed.
Oh.
So, yeah.
So, Chef Clem, is our burger not burning?
Nah. Here's the thing about a burger. People turn too quickly and they don't get that crust. The crust is really important. You want, like, a serious crust. Oh, there we go. I'll show you now. You see, you want that dark crust on there. And as soon as you turn it over...
You don't turn it back.
Yeah. If you really have to, if your burger's not cooked through... We've now opened 3 pieces of cheese, so we're going to have to use 3 slices of cheese.
Let's use it. This is a triple cheese.
It's a triple cheese burger. While it's still hot, get your cheese on there. Let that start melting. I'm going to clean up over here.
Okay.
Okay, now, how do you like your burger? This is absolutely your burger. So
I don't use butter, so I prefer to use the sauce for the base of my bun.
And it's a nice, generous amount of sauce. I like that.
Can I just do the one and then you do the other? So you show me how you like it.
We're only going to get one patty, so we're going to make one burger.
Perfect. We're only making one burger. I like the lettuce to cup it.
Mm-hmm.
And then we get all the little toppings at the bottom. With some onions.
What would you never put on a burger?
Oh, I want the cooked onions.
Sorry. Oh, yes, caramelized onions.
We were meant to caramelize onions. So not those ones, but the caramelized ones. Uh-huh. What do I never put on a burger?
Yeah, what's like the one thing that you see on a burger and you're just like, nah, I'm out?
I don't like mixing anything fishy with, like... So I can mix bacon. Like, when it comes to mixing proteins, I can add pork to it. I can add chicken. Uh-huh. I can combine those flavors, but never anything fishy. So if you're going to come with some anchovy something, you've lost me.
Okay. And just if we can go back to yesterday, it'll bring back some memories. So you are against chicken and tuna together in one vibe.
Yeah.
Sorry, Raul de Mornay.
Okay. He did that yesterday. If you missed it, we had a little Sami sandwich challenge. Let's just top it off with more.
Of course. I'm not really...
Butterfingers today.
Butterfingers, because they are brioche buns, fortified with butter and eggs. There we go. So I'm not that picky about burgers. I do love a plain cheeseburger. I'm fine with pineapple, whatever, on a burger. I'm cool with that.
Oh, yes.
But the classic is always my favorite.
Oh.
This looks amazing. Let me just ask, I can't ask the cameraman over here because he's a vegan. Cameraman Petey, would you pay 100 rand for this burger?
He's shaking
yes.
He's shaking yes. Zoe.
I rate you just starting, like, get off a food truck, start making burgers.
A little food truck burger.
Yes!
Zoe's buns. Okay, wait, that's going way south. Okay, listen, if you want to get your hands on this recipe, it is available on our website, expressoshow.com. And if you shop, the only mince to shop is the ones you choose at Woolworths. And it's now available at new, lower prices in store, online, as well as on the app. Chef Clem, who's going to have this burger? We're going to share it.
We're going to share.
Okay, we'll share.
This is the one time you're allowed to slice a burger in half.
Oh, is that not allowed?
Not allowed. It's against the company rules, the country's rules. That looks like such a good
burger. Now that your mouth is watering, you're gonna have a little bit of break to get it swallowed down, because tomorrow, well, just after the break, we've got some really exciting stuff. Miss SA is launching her swimwear line, which is gonna be great, but also Adam is back. And we've had Adam in studio a little bit earlier, and if you heard Adam sing, you are going to work a little bit later. It's amazing. So we'll catch you after the break.
If your cooking makes you proud, then you might be Mzansi's next cooking star. To be a part of Color Your Plate with Koo on SABC2, show us how a healthier you starts with you and your tasty plate. Take a video of yourself creating a colorful meal and tell us why you should be Mzansi's next cooking star. WhatsApp your entry to 072-741-5357 and you could be in the new season. Plus, stand to win your share of prizes valued at 500,000 Rand. Color Your Plate with Koo.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Expresso on S3. We have something very exciting for you.
Yes, former Miss SA Shurufatsu Musida has launched a brand new swimwear brand with Woolworths. Earlier, Kuhle got to sit down and chat to her about her children's book, but now let's find out more about the swimsuit range.
Carl and Zoe, thank you so much. We are back coming to you live. Zoe, I hope that you are on standby because I've got something for you and for all the women who are currently watching right now. Apa Mzansi. Imbe is a brand that is derived with the purpose of empowering women of all shapes to ensure that they feel seen and beautiful. It was co-founded by Ushudu and it's distributed at selected Woolworths stores across the country. We are about to get into all of that. Shudu, first of all, talk to us about the name Imbe. What language is it and what does it mean?
Imbe is Venda and it's short for Imberani. So when I was 10 years old, I knew that my first child would be Imberani, right?
Nice.
And this is my first child, which is Imbe, and it means to sing or to praise in my language, Kachivenda. So that's the story behind Imbe. We wanted women to feel confident and to sing confidently about their bodies, and that's the reason we named it that.
And what is the inspiration, you know, to release a swimwear line?
So my business partners and I, Colleen and Titi, we had all like different stories. I was a model, and in the modeling industry, you know, there's a lot of like body dysmorphia and how you look at yourself, whether it be times you're going to a fitting room or I'm at a fitting and I'm trying on swimwear and it doesn't fit me properly. And there's like, it's gaping at the back or like there's a weird, you know, situation there. Or even like personally, you go into the ocean, you come out and like it's see-through, you know, and it's like those little things and they all had different stories to share. For me, it was like different parts of my body that I didn't feel too comfortable confident about. Mm. And we were speaking about women and how they see themselves in swimwear. And that's how it came together to make a brand for women by women, where we are addressing issues that most women face in order to feel beautiful and also address those issues. So even with the fabric that we used, so it's double layered. So even if you're going into the ocean, it's not going to be see-through. Mm. You're not going to have that weird situation at the bottom, and it fits just right. Yeah.
I love that. And also, one thing about South African women, we have beautiful bodies, man. Mm. All shapes and sizes, curves, and all of it. And we love to celebrate that. And it's important to be at the beach or wherever you want to be and feel comfortable and beautiful. Now, please take us through some of the designs that we can expect from Inde. I know that we've got models right now in Cape Town.
Okay, so we've got Nike. Mm. So that comes in gold, and it also comes in yellow. So that one, personally, is my favorite. It's named after my sister, Zonaka. So Zonaka means it is beautiful, and Nike is short for that. So that one is almost like the sun. So it's a beautiful bikini, and I love it so much because of how it's designed. And you can also adjust the straps on the side, depending on the tightness you want, and also with the straps at the top, with the bikini top, the tightness depending on your bust as well, to make sure that you're comfortable and everything is covered properly. There's Anza, which I also love, which comes in blue and mocha, and that one is like a full body swimsuit. And what I love about that one is that you can wear it on the beach, obviously, but if you're also going to like a beach party or like you're just going out, you can put on jeans on top, and it's also quite cute. It's got a nice knot here, so it also just makes you feel comfortable if you just feel like, oh no, you just want to hide something, or you just want to make it look more flattering. It's really, really up to you. So I love that one because it's got a dual purpose. And then we've got Mpo. Mpo means gift. So Anza means to grow, and then Mpo means gift. And that's the one that's a blue, comes only in blue, and it's got like beautiful knots here. So it's got a little space in between, and it's got beautiful knots. So I love my burgers, personally, and really? I love to eat. So when I'm at the beach, or I'm at like when I'm on holiday, I like putting on my swimwear in the morning, and that's my look for the day, put on shorts. Mm. And when I'm eating burgers, sometimes you feel like, okay, I've eaten a little bit too much and this is starting to feel tight. Mm. The beautiful thing about Mpo is that you can adjust the knots so it can loosen up a little bit and still make you look like, you know, things are still...
Give you that room
to feel comfortable, but also still feel beautiful because of how it's designed. You're not going to show that you've eaten a little bit, you know? like with me, when I eat a burger, I just want to sleep. Yeah. But like it gives you space to actually adjust the knots and give you room to breathe, which is what I love about it. And then the last one that we have, the Anza Mpo. So I'm just remembering the names. Yeah. Nike, Anza Mpo. And then Konani. Mm. Konani means friend. Koni. Mm. So Koni is a beautiful, beautiful swimwear. It's gold. So that one is really, really beautiful, and it's really, you know, it gives you that extra edge. Yeah. And I love that one because it's really like high-waisted here, and you can adjust the straps so it can help your bust if you want to lift it up or you just want to, you know, keep it more conservative. But the beautiful thing about all the swimwear is that it's double-layered, like I said, so it gives you that, you know, extra protection. So when you're going into the ocean, it's not going to be see-through. It also just ensures that, like, everything is covered up the way that you want to, and it's very flattering. But also, they all have padding in them. So if you want that extra lift, it gives you that extra lift. But if you feel like, I've got enough lift, you can also just take it out and put it back in if you want to. So we've been really... There's been a lot of attention to detail in each design, and we're very, very proud of it.
I mean, beyond the beautiful aesthetics, the rich colors and different designs, it feels like it's intentional. It feels like truly it is by women and for women.
Exactly.
Tell us more about the partnership with Woolworths. It will be available, or currently available, at selected Woolworths stores across the country.
Yes, yes. So this swimwear will be distributed across 5 flagship Woolworths stores. Mm-hmm. V&A in Cape Town, at the Woolworths there, Canal Walk in Cape Town, the Woolworths there, and then the Woolworths store in Sandton City, the Woolworths store in Menlyn, and also Gateway Woolworths. And we've already done appearance as meet and greets for customers who want to come and see the IMEI product, and we help them pick up the swimwear. So this past weekend, we were at the Woolworths V&A and Canal Walk Woolworths with my business partner, Colleen. Mm-hmm. And this weekend, actually, we're going to be in Sandton City on the Saturday, Menlyn Mall on the Sunday. It's going to be TT and I. And please, they must come and join us at the Woolworths store, because the beauty of Woolworths is that it aligns to the values that we as IMEI have. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why this partnership and them distributing it was perfect, because of the attention to detail that they have towards their products, but also their customers. So we are very excited to be working with Woolworths, because it really does have a special place in my heart. And yeah, it's been beautiful.
It's a love letter from Usudu by women, for women, distributed at selected Woolworths stores. Thank you so, so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Talking to us about your new book that's upcoming and dropping on the 8th of November, and of course, IMEI, which is available at selected Woolworths stores. Shudu, you are incredible, a global inspiration. Once again, thank you for joining
us. Thank you so much, Kutle.
Now, do the right thing. If you want to meet Miss South Africa 2020, make sure to be at Sandton City this Saturday and Menlyn Mall on Sunday. This is us wrapping it up here in Johannesburg. I hope that you have a fantastic day further. Gamalambo Kuhle Adams, mwah! Back to you guys in studio.
Thanks, Kuhle. Absolutely amazing designs over there. So make sure you go out and support local creatives, just like Miss Essa.
Oh, definitely. And don't forget that it's Woolies Black Friday with new deals every single week. Get 30% off women's, men's and kids' denim, as well as women's and girls' dresses until the 29th of October when shopping online at woolworths.co.za. This offer is only available online, and there are some T's and C's that apply.
It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso. You're on S3, and with us on our Espresso stage once again is Adam, the glamour clown. Now, her accomplishments continue to accumulate, and the bar continues to be raised with every single performance. And when you see a performance, it's not a performance that you see, you experience it. It's something that you absorb into your soul and you'll never ever forget. As the images we show you on screen allow that to give you a texture as to what this is all about. It is not just one person, oh no. This is Adam, an experience. A vision, a moment. Hi, Adam.
Hi, wow, what an intro.
You're welcome.
Dang, I feel like I won an Oscar. That's so stunning. Yes. Wowie zowie.
No, but this is the great thing. I mean, watching you perform on the show has been wonderful today. And but the thing is, you're also a business person, and you have this amazing company called App Media.
Yes.
Who happens to be hosting Trinity the Tuck.
Right.
That's the rumor's true.
I mean,
this is not just normal. I mean, if you understand the drag community, Trinity the Tuck, this is a proper monument.
She's a diva.
Right?
She's a diva, yeah. And you know what? We're so fortunate because we worked with her a couple years ago, also around my birthday, by the way, it's my birthday.
When?
Today.
Hey!
Yeah.
Happy birthday!
Oh, well.
Sorry, I meant...
Thank you. I'm finally 21. Okay, it's great.
What?
No, I'm not 21.
Oh, my word.
Yeah, you know. Comedy. Comedy, I do.
I was going to jump on a piano for you now, but okay, we'll do that later. Continue.
Yeah, the Tom Cruiser that has.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's incredible to have Trinity here. You know, the fact that she came through and the fact that I get to work with her again, she is a consummate professional. She's one of the nicest people I've ever met. She's so successful. She's so incredible. I'm honestly just honored to share the stage with her again. It's going to be amazing. The show, hello, all my cameras. The show is going to be so good. I'm giving you all the shots. The show is going to be great. The show is going to be incredible. So please pull up. It's literally, as far as I know, the biggest drag show that has happened on the African continent so far.
I believe so, yeah.
Yes, we're doing it in a theater. We're not just up in the clubs like we normally are. We're doing the full shebang. So, you know. Get the tickets. Get the tickets from us out.
The way you did it to camera, it's like you want to tell the camera, like, and I'm telling you, like you want to do that thing.
Right? I am.
That should you should toast that moment with like a Jennifer Hudson song. That'd be cool.
I might. I mean, if you got, do you have one on hand?
Maybe we
you
can. Have one. Let's give it a shot. Maybe we should try.
Okay, cool. Someone sing it from the back.
All right, let's go.
The best man I'll ever know. There's no way I can ever go. No, no, there's no way. No, 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 no way. I'm living without you. I'm not living without you. I don't wanna be free.
The very glamorous Adam the Glamour Clown to please take a bow. Catch Adam and the Trinity of the Tuck live in Cape Town on the 28th of October. It starts at 2 p.m. Wow. at the Homecoming Theatre. And you can also catch Adam on Sunday, the 29th of October at the Barnyard Theatre in Menlyn. Tickets are available at Quicket. Oh, if you're in, you're in for a treat.
Yeah, no, I'm very excited. I'm actually going to try make plans to... I've shifted around my diary. I was, like, on my phone going, because I need to make a plan.
Make it happen.
To be there. Yeah.
And then, of course, we go from Trinity to the Tuck to Trinity to the Ruck. Springboks have actually announced their squad. A quick look at it for you, just so you get it fresh. Here it comes on your screen. Ooh. And, Lorenzo, 7-1. We did it again. Rassi, you biscuit.
Yeah, and Jacques, let's not forget it. It's Jacques as well, though. Yes. I'm a bit shocked at this. I thought I was going to see Moody there, you know, on you know, just for the high ball.
Is Bongi in? Bongi, he's in at number two?
Bongi is in at number
suspended.
Two. He's not at all, and that's a good one. Lovely, eh? I can see that Zoe's going to be watching the game. Bongi!
I think big one over there. I don't see Marnie Lubbock's name, and I think that's quite a shocker for most.
Yeah.
Tactical, maybe, but we'll see. And then also Oxen Chairs on the bench. He's an impact player, so that's going to be beautiful.
Yeah, no, definitely. We need Ox to come on.
Yeah.
And not be the one to start off. Let's hope that Kitsi has a good game, though.
Yeah.
I'm loving the fact that we've got that 2019 halfback pairing back again. That's going to be that weather is going to be important. They say that there's going to be some rain, so...
guys. Didn't play so well in the rain the last time.
Yeah, well, that's why the money
So we're going to go one backliner on the bench.
Yeah, 7-1. 7-1, we've got Vali.
Wow.
Vali Pasi, Vali Skopi, Vali Atlupi.
Wow. Thank you for being here. Have a beautiful morning.
Cheers, everybody.
Catch you again soon.
Another feel-good production.